this road will lead, we do know you don't have to walk it alone. When you're ready, Cox Media's team of experts will be here to offer thoughtful perspective on messaging and media planning as your customers are evolving how they watch, read, and connect. We're here to help you navigate this together. Cox Media. Better together.
A new Chevy is the smart way to hit the open road this summer. The smart way to road trip and seek new adventures. Go a little farther this summer in a new Chevy. Find new get up and go, find new roads. Enjoy the open road and make no monthly payments for the rest of summer on all 2022 Silverado 1500 pickups. Plus, get 2.49% financing when you finance with GM Financial. Find new roads at your local Chevy dealer.
Week 4 in the CFL kicks off in the nation's capital. Will red-black fans finally see a win at home? Can they slow down Nathan Rourke? Performance this past weekend, 436 yards. What does Nathan Rourke have for an encore performance? And we all know he has his game face on, and we have our game faces on because it's Thursday Night Football presented by 7-Eleven. I'm Kate Burness. That's Davis Sanchez. That's Dave Naylor and Milt Stegall. Davis, we've got the Lions in town to face the Red Blacks. We know all the hype is still around Nathan Rourke. Yep. What are you expecting from him tonight? And maybe a few challenges coming his way.
Yeah, I expect the Ottawa Red Blacks to try to take away his first reads, make things a little more difficult for him. And the way to do that is to get up on him, play some press, and then what Nathan likes to do and does so well is get into his checkdowns. What do you do? You got to hug up on that checkdown. So one of the three things going to happen is either going to go deep and get some big shots, or he's going to tuck it and run, which, as you know, Gunn, he's really good at.
That's one of the things certainly he's done a lot in his college career. He had a lot of designed runs, and I know that he can show that. He hasn't really shown that yet in the CFL. Yeah. But speaking of running, I'm going to go to the other side of the ball. We've talked so much about the air. I'm going to talk about the ground game and talk about William Powell, the former Red Black, who was part of that free agent exodus a few years ago to Saskatchewan. I mean, he's in his 30s. He's still sustaining his abilities as a running back in this league. Yeah. He's been injured in training camp. He gets his first start tonight. That would be a big assist to the Ottawa offense.
What they need to do, Davis? Get up on him.
Get up on him!
That's the inside joke. You know what? And you talk about the running game for Ottawa. What about the running game for BC? Yeah, Nathan Rourke is the key, but also the Butler is back. Yeah. Can he get it going? Because if he gets it going, it's going to be tough for Ottawa to beat them. Definitely.
We're going on a road trip tomorrow, by the way. Dave, by the way, you may be in the mix.
He's in the mix?
Well, he's done so well on the panel tonight. I mean, there's some good chemistry and camaraderie. Like we might just keep him around. Meanwhile, the BC Lions ready to take the field over at TD Place, taking on the Red Blacks. We will get you to kickoff right after this. The BC Lions rolling, going to the nation's capital, though, against that Ottawa Red Blacks defense.
I'm all about Nathan Rourke. His receiving core as well.
Big hit for the Ottawa Red Blacks.
Alonzo Adai lowering the boom there.
Marilyn Petras of Princeton, BC. This is your chance to win groceries for a year thanks to Save On Foods' $1 million touchdown to win. If a kickoff is returned, you win groceries for a year. If two are returned, you could win $1 million. Let's get you to TD Place now and join Marshall Ferguson, Matt Dunnigan.
Oh, Canada, welcome to one of the marquee weekends on the CFL calendar, and what better way to then to kick it off from the nation's capital in a star-studded matchup between the hometown Red Blacks in desperate need of a win to validate their vastly improved play, and the BC Lions, led by Kid Canada himself, Matt Dunnigan. Nathan Rourke has announced his presence to the CFL like a firework on a long weekend. It has been explosive to kick off his starting career.
Well said and timely. This kid, these aren't sparklers we're talking about, or little blackjacks. We're talking about a kid that is lighting it up and seeing the field like a seasoned veteran. And I'm scratching my head. I'm talking to everybody trying to get a bead on it, as well as, you know, that the Red Blacks are trying to do the same. Had 2 weeks to prepare for this kid. And, you know, Jeremiah Mazzoli is scratching and clawing to find his way more readily into the red zone and end zone this week, because he's only got one touchdown in 2 weeks going up against the defending champions Winnipeg Blue Bombers. So Soli's looking to get his mojo, and the young quarterback Nathan Rourke is looking to sustain his.
Great effort from the Red Blacks in the first two games against Winnipeg, but effort did not result in wins. They are 0-2 as we get the opening kickoff to kick off Canada Day weekend, as Luches Purifoy will return it out just past the 25-yard line. And we get our first look this evening at Nathan Rourke.
Yeah, so Nathan, they won the toss, and he says they want the ball. Why not when you're in fire like this kid has been? Absolutely unconscious, and seems like he's poised, and we'll see what he can do against this Red Blacks defense, one that I have a lot of respect for and has gained a lot of respect across the league because of Mike Benavides, their defensive coordinator.
Lucky Whitehead in motion. No touchdowns on the year, but leads BC in combined yardage. They begin with an inside handoff. It goes to James Butler. Not a bad start to the season for himself either, as we get a chance to meet the Lions offense, brought to you by Expedia.
Yeah, and you talk about guys that have stepped up. This offensive line's been they're having a lot of fun blocking for this kid. And talked to Sook Chung before the ball game. He says, Matty, he says, it's a joy to have the kid leading this football team. Dominic Rhymes, a little different version of Rhymes this year. He's leaned down, and he's a deep threat in a big way. This football team's loaded with talent, despite having Brian Burnham not in the lineup.
Second down and long. Rourke's first chance to make a throw down the field. It goes up in the air, off the hands of the intended receiver. That's the newcomer on the outside that time, Josh Pearson, who couldn't haul it in.
Yeah, and I'll tell you right now, Marshall, Luches Purifoy mishandles the opening kickoff. We see a misread by Rourke on the RPO. And then here, this is a ball that should have been caught. So I don't know if it's jet lag or this short week, but that's not a good sign for the BC Lions starting out like that.
Two and outs extremely rare early in this season for the Lions, but they do go two and out to begin here as Terry Williams back to return, this time from Stephen Flintoff. A roll down inside the 40-yard line. Williams picks it up, knifes his way for a return of about 5 yards on the play. Jeremiah Masoli gets his opportunity, and man, he has been putting up yardage like you wouldn't believe through the first 2 weeks against Winnipeg, but it's a matter of finishing.
Yeah, it is. Only one touchdown in those two ball games. Tip of the hat to the Bombers D, Richie Hall, and what he's been able to do over there for a number of years now. And hey, I look at this as I was excited when I saw this schedule and I was doing this game. I said, Jeremiah Masoli, Nathan Rourke. I said, has it played out the way it has? Let's go.
Read my mind. First and 10. For the Red Blacks, Justin Hardy, a late scratch in this one. So Terry Williams, the returner, does get the start. That field side receiver, inside handoff, just like the Lions. And we'll get a look here at the Ottawa offense with William Powell back in the fold.
Yeah, and he does so many different things for you, William Powell. You've got Hunter Stewart, a left guard, just a mammoth of a man up there. You're talking about offensive linemen that have kind of piecemealed together, come together quickly, according to Paul LaFelice, and he's giving them a lot of praise. Powell and Ackland, the two big guns for this offense.
William Powell comes into tonight one rushing yard ahead of Doug Flutie in career rushing yards, as Masoli will look to throw on second and 7 over the top and throws it away. And back to back two and outs, and not much going down the field that time for Masoli.
All the talk about the Lions offense and not a lot of talk about their defense because they just hadn't been on the football field. Last week, 19 minutes, 51 seconds, in and around that range. That's not a lot of time, folks. When the offense is sustaining drives, the defense is fresh. And we saw fresh legs right there get after Jeremiah Mazzoli, one of the most elusive quarterbacks in the CFL.
Shai Ross back to return. Nice kick this time. Comes down from Richie Leone and Ross. Oh, a huge hit. And buckets go popping. Down the field, making the play that time. It's Basambombo, the Laval product, backup linebacker, making his name on special teams. Big shot down the field. Leone sends it down, and Basambombo finishes it off. Big hits to kick off Canada Day weekend here on the CFL on TSN.
Across the country, businesses have had to adjust how they operate and make difficult decisions to protect their employees, customers, and communities. While we don't yet fully know where this road will lead, we do know you don't have to walk it alone. When you're ready, Cox Media's team of experts will be here to offer thoughtful perspective on messaging and media planning as your customers are evolving how they watch, read, and connect. We're here to help you navigate this together. Cox Media. Better together.
A new Chevy is the smart way to hit the open road this summer. The smart way to road trip and seek new adventures. Go a little farther this summer in a new Chevy. Find new get up and go, find new roads. Enjoy the open road and make no monthly payments for the rest of summer on all 2022 Silverado 1500 pickups. Plus, get 2.49% financing when you finance with GM Financial. Find new roads at your local Chevy dealer.
Thursday Night Football is brought to you by 7-Eleven, where you get fast 24/7 delivery on game day, including Slurpee drinks.
Welcome back to the nation's capital as we are knotted at zeros. A couple of two and outs to kick this one off, and Nathan Rourke gets his second possession of the ballgame. Two receivers to the wider side of the field. He'll look that direction, trying to find a corner route over the top. Drops the dime right on the money that time, Matty.
What the heck is that? You know, I'm thinking no way is he going to try to fit that in there because he's got to throw it about 45 yards on a rope, and that's exactly what he does. And he's looking this way the whole time. He's looking right. He goes shallow. Now he goes over the top, and he fits this all right over the top. Oh, my gosh.
Welcome to the 2022 CFL season for Anthony Pixada.
Jeez.
Checks in for Abdul Kanna, who's out with an injury sustained in practice, and right away they go after him. As we get another look at the footwork, the release, the time, all the things we've been gushing about all week long with this kid.
I guarantee you, this is somebody else that's going back the other way, and that is perfectly spotted. And that's just a Teyata's right there, and he can't really play it much better. Oh, yeah, that's just a look at what we've been seeing for the first 2 weeks.
People saying, well, why are you guys going so crazy about this work yet? That's why. Right there, second and eight.
Uh-oh.
Ball tipped in the air, up for grabs.
Oh! Oh, my goodness.
Pearson makes up for the drop on the first drive, and it looks like it might be good enough for the first down, or at least very close where they'll bring in the short yardage package.
I mean, sometimes, you know, the football's oblong, and it bounces all different crazy ways. Get your hands up here. That ball's batted up, and it's a volleyball and a rebound. And he just goes up and gets it. Pearson skies it for him, does a nice job of recognizing it. That ball's off the helmet, goes about 30 feet in the air, and then he just goes and long arms it and high points it and brings it down.
Rourke stays in with the short yardage package. Sprint to the left. Flags are down. Looks like it'll be offside, but Rourke doesn't care. Down the left sideline. Showing off the speed. Will he score? He will. Touchdown, BC.
So we got here. Southside's Ottawa. They're like shell-shocked. Had a nice two and out on the first drive. First time we've seen that in 60-plus minutes from the BC Lions offense. And then here, we got Rourke, taking it to the house. Says he's a 4-7. Looks a lot faster than that.
I was
Marshall.
About to say, when we talked to him this week,
the Ottawa defensive line,
as it was against Ottawa, the touchdown will stand.
Touchdown.
You said to him, "What's your fastest 40 time?"
Yeah.
He said 4-7. You said 4-4-7. He said, "No."
Big difference.
No. He looked like he was 4-4-7 on this one.
Well, you know, a lot of talk about his speed and what he did at University of Ohio as a Bobcat, and I mean, one, he's outrunning linebackers and D linemen there, but still, he made that look relatively easy and took it to the house. And you talk about fireworks, there you sound right there.
Looked a lot like a guy that used to wear 12 and played football in Ottawa. Maybe we'll get into that throughout the evening.
Oh, nice.
Nice little run down that left sideline. And in case you didn't think that Nathan Rourke's completion
too
percentage.
Too many players on Ottawa. That penalty's declined.
Wow.
Convert is good.
Had some magic on it as well. He gets the great completion. He gets the big run of 50 yards down the left sideline. Kid Canada is off and running. Early lead for the Lions here in Ottawa.
Yeah, and taking this, everybody crashes down in here, and what Nathan Rourke is going to do, he's just go out and around, and Lucky's going to go here. Gives the big boys trying to secure the edge an opportunity, and it's off to the races. And we know who wins that one. 4-7 looked mighty fast on that play. Ball's bouncing a little crazy for the BC Lions. We saw it on that possession. Nathan Rourke says, "I got this." 3rd and 1, takes it to the house.
Previous longest rush was 33. Now he's added a 50 to his total as Terry Williams. Great return down the sideline, running through Flintoff. He pushes him out of bounds. At the end of the play is Marco Dubois, the special teamer, gets in on the action at the end of the play, and a late flag is out. Some jawing between the benches here in Ottawa, but 4 plays, 82 yards in a 150, and all of a sudden this BC offense gets them a lead, and this has been the story for them throughout the early season. Now Ottawa has to answer.
Yeah, and it hasn't been pretty by no means. A deflected ball, nice rebound by Pearson.
Major
zero
foul, player misconduct penalty, BC number 2, 15 yard penalty, first down Ottawa.
And that one goes against Kevin Francis, backup weak side linebacker, and after the play, so if he gets another, he will be gone from the ball game.
Big presence, 6'6", 265 pounds, just a specimen, and takes a silly penalty on that. Gives the Red Blacks tremendous field position here. Take that all day. Here's the play. Flintoff takes down Williams, left of the screen. They're tangling up a little bit. Just that second guy, he just kind of jabbed him with his right arm.
Dubois, he'll draw that out of a lot of people as they
trying to figure out why they're going back here.
Backwards. After speaking to the bench, Paul Lapolis in his Canada Day red wants an explanation as well.
We would like one too. Regardless of starting at their own 45. That's not bad field position. I'll take that as a QB all day.
Solely back to action. His second possession of the ball game. Rolling to the right a little, moving the pocket underneath, incomplete. That will be the first pass that's intended for Nate Bahar that has not been caught on the year as we get a look at the BC defense.
Yeah, from Oregon State, you got Owen Watcham here. I just love watching this kid play. Gets after the quarterback extremely well. Just somebody to keep an eye on as he continues to progress as a young man. This is a guy that starts everything for the BC Lions defense. Lucas Purifoy. And that's coming straight from Ryan Phillips and TJ Lee, the leader of the pack in the back end. That's secondary.
Solely 71% completion rate through the first two games. 0-for-2 to kick this one off. Pressure is on 2nd and long. He has to get rid of it. And he does. It's completed. And he'll be just shy as Jalen Acklin adds to his total on the season.
About 2.5 yards shy, it looks like.
And it will be the kicking unit that comes out with Richie Leone.
I mean, looked like they were starting the other side, BC side of the field. Then they were taken back to the 45. Pressure, can't complete a ball, and then one that's a little short. It's a good spot for fake punt, you know?
Middle of the field, always dangerous. You can never count that out with Bob Dice, special teams coordinator. This one floating down to Shia Ross. Got hammered by Bassett Bombo on the last return, and this time great coverage. Antoine Pruneau makes the tackle as we get a look at Nathan Rourke and Russ Jackson, the legend, the Canadian quarterbacks here on Canada Day weekend, the CFL on TSN. Well, when you think Canadian quarterbacks, you think Russ Jackson, but whoa, some of these numbers. The completion percentage, Canadian record from Rourke. 5 total touchdowns in his first game, tying the record of Russ Jackson. 436 passing yards, a Canadian quarterback record, and 39 completions. And what Russ Jackson did, there's a reason we're still talking about him. Look at some of these numbers, Matt Dunigan.
Yeah, and as good as he was on the field, he's better off the field just to... heck of a representative for the Canadian Football League for such a long time now, just decade after decade. Russ Jackson, his beautiful wife, such great ambassadors for everything that the CFL stands for. A chance to speak to him briefly yesterday and get his insights on Nathan Rourke. I'll share that with you in a little bit.
Inside handoff gets stuck, but Russ and Lois long been great ambassadors for the CFL game, and the way that he's playing has to bring a smile to Russ's face watching back home tonight.
Yeah, Russ is kind of like everybody, kind of holding his breath, watching this kid. You know, when's this bubble going to pop? How's he going to react under pressure? Well, tonight's going to be a real good showing of that and how he reacts to this tough Red Blacks defense. And so far, it's been his legs that have gotten the job done, and we'll see how it progresses.
As he uses his arm likely here on 2nd and 10 as flags come up. You were noticing, Maddie, during one of the TV timeouts pregame as Dave Foxcroft, our lead official.
BC number 51. 5-yard penalty remains 2nd down.
It'll go against Peter Godbear, the center, but how relaxed Rourke is, waiting outside of the huddle, gathering his thoughts.
Yeah, composure. You know, to me, that's what that is. Don't step in there until you're ready to go. Collect your thoughts. You've got 1,000 things going through your mind. Collect them, step in there, take control, and get in and out and play fast. And we've seen him do that the first 2 weeks.
Just a quick look at the defense there. Great shot of the eyes. Surveying on 2nd down and 15. Stands in the pocket, sets up a screen.
Oh, you got
drops
a lot
it
of
down
room.
To Butler. Blockers in front, runs into a wall of Red Blacks tacklers.
Ooh.
Avery Williams taps the face mask and says, "I'm right here all night, James Butler."
Yeah. We saw him exit his stage left last week on a hit like that. Happy to see him back out here. The screen was set up nicely as you watch the big boys get out in front, invite them up, and then here comes Suk Chung. He starts seeking and destroying, and then James goes and puts him in 3rd and short.
Goes for it deep in their own end. That'll be enough to move the sticks. I got a feeling that Mike Benavides, defensive coordinator for the Red Blacks, might be okay with a gain of 2 after the last quarterback sneak had a significantly different result.
But really, really bent because of that 2nd and long situation there, 2nd and 15, and they pick up 14, putting them in a scenario where they can go for it on 3rd down, and that's got to stink because you had them backed up where you wanted, get another 2 and out, and get great field position. Now the drive continues.
Late homework by Rourke after breaking the huddle. Motion Javon Katoy back into the short side. Rourke loads it up, throws some air under it. Out to that wide side, and it is incomplete. Very nearly pulled in that time by Dominique Rimes, making his return to the nation's capital after 2 touchdowns last week against the Argos.
Yeah, and Nathan's right. Nathan's target is right here in front of you. You can see him right here, and it's a fly pattern. Go get it. I think ball spotted pretty nicely on his outside shoulder. I think if you ask Dominic, he'd like to have that one over. That ball's catchable right there.
0-for-3 on 2nd down so far this evening are the BC Lions. We're trying to change that. Rips it to Lucky Whitehead. It'll be completed, but well short of the first down. So 0-for-4 for a group that's been converting at 68.6% so far through their first 2 ball games.
Yeah, and these aren't big victories. These are the little things that the Red Blacks defense does consistently, much like we've seen Winnipeg's defense do over the last several years. And that's why they have so much praise and focus on them. But the Red Blacks are very similar. These are big wins for them, I think, in little flashes. These 2 and outs, these shorter drives, and getting them off the field, putting an element of doubt in the BC Lions offense.
This one drops out of bounds, and so the flag will come up with a legal kick out of bounds. Good starting field position once again for Ottawa.
Yeah, and this is the type of stuff that I'm talking about. We saw on Lucas Purifoy mishandles the opening kickoff. We see Flintoff punting out of bounds. You see players taking silly penalties. You got a bounce that went their way. BC Lions are not sharp right now, I'm just saying. You know, that score is a little misleading right now, 7-0.
Get a look
legal
here at some
bounds,
of the
BC number 41.
Statistics that have been jaw-dropping, significantly
Ottawa.
Different results at 2-0, 0-2 on the season. But, Matt, these passing yardage totals so far have been something to watch.
Yeah, and, you know, we could talk about them all day long. We look at those there, and they're very comparable on both sides with Jeremiah and Rourke. But the only thing that matters is the win-loss. And no doubt, these are two high-potent offenses that can get it done.
Four receivers to the wide side for Masoli. He'll keep it on play action. Throws it underneath. And again, incomplete. Intended for Nate Bahar.
Yeah, and he got pressure in his face on the RPO there. And right in front of his face, he feels it and he sees it. And I believe it's Betts that gets there. Yep. Yeah, and it just made him get a little happy feet. And he threw the ball off balance, couldn't target it the way he wanted to. Betts gets there, and we know his motor's always running. So you can get used to that. He's going to be always churning out there. 90 made that play.
Extra linebacker in the ball game here for BC. And a pressure look on 2nd and 10. Masoli, open receiver, and it is completed.
Wow.
It looks like in front of T.J. Lee.
No.
No, they're going to come from the back and say incomplete.
Yeah. Ackland, when he got up, you know, he didn't look like, yeah, I made that sweet catch.
No.
It looked like he was, like, doubting. And that ball definitely bounced.
We get a better look at it here if the first down marker stays out of the way. Yeah, that bounced. There's a reason he wasn't going to win an Oscar for that one.
Bounce off his hand, or did it bounce off the turf?
That looks short, but Masoli would be frustrated by that one with an open receiver on 2nd down.
Well, BC Lions, talk about their defense. There's a 2-and-out for them. Much needed.
Three straight 2-and-outs to start as a sidewinder. This time comes off the right foot of Richie Leone and right into the fire again. Goes Shai Ross, and it will be a flag coming out. They'll move up the Lions. And Matthew Schinetti with more on Nathan Rourke when we return to the CFL on TSN. Well, it was a Canadian record last week all over the field. Nathan Rourke taking advantage and finding the end zone with more down to field level for the first time this evening. Here's Matthew Schinetti.
Well, Marcia, talk about Nathan Rourke's eyes. You can typically draw a line from one offense all the way to another. Jordan McSimmick's offense, the offensive coordinator for the BC Lions, all the way to Mark Trestman and Anthony Calvillo through Scott Milanovic and Ricky Ray, Jason Moss and Michael Riley. It's progression-based offense that looks for medium throws. I was asking Nathan Rourke about those visual cues that he's looking for. He says, listen, I may not be like those great quarterbacks yet, but I trust my eyes, I trust my throw, I don't care what the other defenses are doing, so I'm going to go ahead and constantly go through my mental reps. As for the legs, Ricky Ray just announced in the Hall of Fame, I can say that right now that Nathan Rourke has better legs than Anthony Calvillo and Ricky Ray, guys.
I don't know, a young AC could rip around pretty good,
you know,
Matthew.
A young AC will tell you that he can rip around pretty good.
And we get a look at the legs here of Rourke as he gets a gain of around 9, maybe 10, we'll see where they spot it, but his progression and his ability to read play after play after play. 4 of 6, 50 yards, but using the legs when he needs to on plays like this, Matty.
Yeah, it's impressive. And I think this is what you have to do with any quarterback with a defense like this is move the launch point. You saw him do that right there. Gives him a first down. And certainly we know he's capable of doing this. That's what he did at Ohio U, tore it up there. And now he just wants to settle down and become a passer. Forced to use those legs so far early.
Does get the first down, has to get rid of this one quickly, and he does. It's Javon Katoy in space, makes the grab. And I thought it was great this week when we were able to hear from Paul Appelese his comparison of Masoli and Rourke. Runners in the NCAA, go to the pros, you have to throw it around a lot more, and you basically figure it out on the fly. They've both done so successfully early on.
Yeah, and we're just talking about how quickly that kid, 12, is doing it. Jeremiah's been in the league now, and Paul Appelese recognizes greatness, and this kid's got a lot of it, and he's been giving us some doses of it here in the first 2+ weeks.
Yeah, that one comes out the side of Rourke's hand, and look at him. He's frozen in his footwork. He knows that one was a little off balance. You can tell how in tune he is with his mechanics, and he doesn't like that one.
Yeah, and you really wouldn't because of the result. But I was more concerned with Katoy, who's like 6 foot five, 250 pounds, hunting and pecking after he caught that first and 10 pass, but that one's right in the dirt. His mechanics, balance is not there. He never followed through. It's gonna happen.
He's human once in a while. Punt drops down here to Terry Williams. No yards will be the flag on this one as well, as long snapper Tanner Dahl gets himself. The CFL on TSN keeps on rolling tomorrow with Friday night football action. Don't miss the Elks against the Ticats. Showdown at 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific, and exclusive TSN coverage all weekend long. And we might have back-to-back nights of Canadian quarterbacks. Trey Ford listed first on the depth chart for Edmonton when it came out earlier on today. A patriotic, perhaps, Chris Jones deciding, you know what, Canada Day weekend? Let's give the kid a chance. Get a run inside by Powell, banging up between the tackles.
Yeah, I like it. Just straight downhill, you know, coming in the eye position, watching move around pre-snap, kind of keeping the defense at bay. Gets right in the eye position right behind a quarterback and dances through a nice hole in the middle.
Not an easy man to bring to the ground. Just
happy to have him back.
Willie P.
For a number of reasons.
Again, a handoff to Powell. Bouncing and cutting. Second down and medium. He'll move the sticks again.
Yeah, I think what you said right there, Marshall, is very pertinent when you talk about William Powell. Is he's a veteran and his patience and how he carries the football. There he was patient, let the hole develop and then stuck his head in there and picked up the first down. Some great numbers since becoming a Red Black and explosive. Finds the end zone quite often, too.
Devontae Williams, Paul Appelese head coach, said he's got some wiggle. Willie P's got the wiggle in the hole. Quick flip out to the sideline. Nate Bahar makes his appearance on the stat sheet for this evening with a nice first down grab.
Yes, it was. It's not an easy catch. Going full speed, torque your body all the way around. Ball's coming too now. Nice strong fingers, grips that in, right in front of Quincy Mauger.
Creates another second and short. The Blacks will go into the gun. Two receivers to the field. They run that more than anybody to start the season.
Nice.
Little jet to Terry Williams, taking advantage of the returner's speed as he turns up field, rips through the tackle, and it's another Red Blacks first down across midfield.
Yeah, I like this play call. Really keeps the defense at bay using his strengths. Big fan of so much going side to side, but he's got Bahar out front and he's explosive in his own right. Missed tackle there, just noting that, because like I said earlier, this team's not as sharp as I've seen in the first 2 weeks.
Quincy Bourget, the free safety, came down to give him a look at the end. The Red Blacks will break the huddle with a fresh set of downs, attacking here on Thursday Night Football. Six-man rush, open into the left side. It's Nate Bahar again, second grab of the ball game. And nice medium game that time against Mauger, rolling down in coverage.
Yeah, Mauger got to come a long way. Make that tackle from the center of the field, and looks like they're trying to exploit that. It's a couple plays here in the last three that we've seen them attack and kind of weed out the free safety, making them cover and make a play.
Through their first two games, Jeremiah Masoli's highest pass efficiency rating has come when he's targeting Nate Bahar.
Nate's kind of taking on a different role this year, I've noticed. You know, over the middle, second down conversions, just banging in the middle, making tough catches.
See where he goes here. Pressure on Masoli. He's hit as he throws. Ackland tries to fight back to it, and a flag will come out against Delvin Bro. The first day of training camp, when Jalen Ackland was a Tiger Cat, he and Delvin Bro got into a fight at Ticats camp. Now one's in Ottawa, the other's in BC, and they battle as it looks like there'll be a flag in the backfield as well.
Yeah. Flags were littered all over the field.
It looks like Boom Guachum, 98, the big D end,
two penalties on the play. Roughing the passer, BC number 98. Offensive pass interference on Ottawa. The difference is 5 yards, but it will be an automatic first down. That's the end of the quarter.
Well, we get a look at it as Boom Gwacham flying into the backfield, trying to add to his tally on the year. One sack so far on the season. Little late. Clean run. Went a little high on Jeremiah Masoli. End of the first. Lions lead 7-0. Thursday night football, the CFL on TSN. Well, the difference through one quarter, Nathan Rourke on a 50-yard rushing touchdown for the BC Lions in this Ottawa offense that's been so explosive through the start of the season. Matt Dunnigan trying to get the wheels turning a little bit here with a solid opportunity in BC territory to begin the second.
Yeah, and I see Jeremiah Masoli, struggling still up against another tough defense. The defense has been looking for some respect in the first 2 weeks, have been overlooked because of the great play of their quarterback Nathan Rourke and offensively, but I look at this football team and I see some glitches in their game earlier in the first quarter, and that score may be a little misleading. If they can, Red Blacks can get points on the board right now, I think this game's going to take on a whole new dimension. Level the playing field here. Great opportunity on that. What I thought was a so-so hit in the quarterback.
Gotcha went up high. They flagged him for it. Moves it forward.
He's 6'5", Marshall.
How else can he go high? William Powell goes low and runs through the tackle for a first down on first down. And back in the lineup, that'll make Paul Lapolis smile as efficiency on the ground on first down opens up everything in this offense, as we saw for so many years with Andrew Harris in Winnipeg.
Yeah, no question. And I really believe that this is the missing link with this offense. Again, it's right up the middle. Hunter Stewart just going to just... It's just right off the center's tail, just right up the middle, and it exploits the secondary into the second level before they can bat an eye.
Jacob Ruby with the big block as well. They try to go back to the jet sweep that they cashed in on second and medium. This time it's stuffed. Good contained by the Lions defense that time.
Yeah, that was great recognition by everybody. Bola Combo out there. Good to see him bounce back from last week's hit. And Ryan Phillips, defensive coordinator, got the title this year. Was the DC last year. Really didn't have the title. Now he's putting his stamp on this defense, and got a lot to say. I had a lot of talk, long talk with him before the ball game. Yeah, he's communicating with his players extremely well.
Betts fires off the ball here on second and long. Masoli will check it down underneath, not where he wanted to go with the football originally. But a good force that time, and excellent defense up front by Gary Peters, who has two interceptions on the air, and Ryan Phillips loves that.
Yeah, almost like he was playing with his younger brother in the backyard. He said, get out of here. It's like, it's too easy, right? Just good coverage. Watch Jeremiah go through his progressions. And no, he wants to. Goes right back to it, but Gary was just on him. He says, get away from me. This is my territory. I love it. You got to have attitude, play with attitude out there. Great football players right there competing.
Peter's third knockdown leads the Lions in that secondary as Lewis Ward comes out to kick this one away. 7 of 8, now 8 of 9 on the season. Late flag comes up and a couple of blows exchanged. And there's going to be another misconduct penalty here. Might be Davon Coleman, who looked like he might have thrown a punch at the end of the play. Yeah, I think you just saw Rick Campbell there mouth the words, was that a punch? As we'll get a look at it for you here at the end of the play. Randy Richards was out there as well, mixing it up on the field goal. And just as they huddle and talk about what the call will be here, that's another field goal from inside 40 yards for the Ottawa Redblacks this season, as they're now 1 of 7.
That's a whole lot of extracurricular activities going on out there on a field goal attempt.
Couple of times we've seen that already. I think these teams understand the importance of this game. BC wants to prove their 2-0 is for real. These are not just blowouts, and Ottawa dearly needs a victory. Right. So you get a look at the left side, and it's Coleman locked up.
It's right here where you're going to see it.
There's Richards that came over to get some work.
A little left jab right there.
Coleman on Purifoy.
See if he connects with it at least.
That's a face mask
hand
turner.
Slap. I mean, you know, that's just, one, you're going to break a finger. Two, you're not going to do any damage.
We have
with
a total of three penalties on the play.
Three.
All player misconducts.
All three.
Ottawa, number 55 and 9. BC, number 0. It will be a first down, BC.
And so no ejection because with the misconduct, if he gets a second, it will be by rule an ejection. But that's four misconduct penalties that we've had in this ball game. And we are early in the second quarter.
But how's it first down, BC?
Two of them against Ottawa.
Yeah. I just elected to have to take the football. A made field goal.
Hey, we'll keep walking in the crowd here. A great Canada Day crowd in Ottawa. You can feel the tension building at TD Place as they continue to wander up the field.
Well, that's beneficial. Right? That's all right. Let's just walk into the middle of the field and start from here.
From the 55, fitting on Canada Day long weekend.
Oh, I love to see those hash marks, so distinctly on the football field now, only 9 yards apart. And I've really seen some instances in the ball games thus far this year where those hashes have made a difference.
Paul Police and Bob Dice out having a discussion. Is the delay as they want an answer for the imbalance and penalties there?
Right. I think we all do.
Get the best explanation they can, and lead official Dave Foxcroft blows it in for Nathan Rourke. First touch of the second quarter. Reads off the running back to the outside. There's Lucky Whitehead making the grab. That'll be his 16th grab of the year.
This is what they should have done in the first series of the ball game. Rourke should have pulled it and stuck it out there, but he gave it to Butler, and Butler was shut down. This time he gets the edge and throws a strike to Lucky. Easy pitch and catch. Exactly what you do with a mobile quarterback and a running back's having such a great season. And James to Butler.
Easy completion that time, and Rourke makes it look so smooth. This time he will give it to Butler. Big blocking up front, but right there in the middle of the pile, Frankie Griffin, the weak side linebacker. And we had a tremendous discussion with the surprisingly soft-spoken Frankie Griffin earlier on this week.
We sure did. The young man that spent 6 years and at Texas State. Got a lot of studying in.
Oh, yeah.
He did.
Told us some of his favorite courses, canoeing, music. As Rourke looks over the top, wide open that time at the 20. Inside the 10, cutting back, stepping out of bounds down around the 4-yard line is where they will end up spotting Keon Hatcher, who signed an extension after week one when he had 4 grabs and a touchdown. They like him here in BC.
Oh, and this ball is put on him in a hurry. I love this angle. Boom. Goes through his progression, steps into it. Nice pocket there established by the big old lineman in front of him. Let's not forget about that. Throws a strike out there. Quickly moving down the field, taking advantage of those two penalties Ottawa served him up with.
Coming into the ball game, BC 9-for-11, converting 81% of their score zone opportunities into touchdowns. David Mackey into the ball game. He'll block as they throw it to Butler. Makes one man miss.
Man.
Touchdown, Lions.
That was too easy. Yeah, they just, like calf roping or herding, they just plucked that calf out of the middle. That was Avery Williams. It looked like they got him on the running back, and no contest. Butler's going to win that 9 out of 10 times. There's your man right there, Avery Williams, on a running back. They got him in space, give it to him, makes one move. Mackey doesn't have to do anything, and Butler's in the end zone. That's just a mismatch.
Nathan Rourke is 8-for-11, 106 yards, and a touchdown through the air to go with the 50-yard run that he scored as well. That's your difference as Ottawa unable to convert, crossing midfield to begin the second quarter. They have to kick a field goal, and it leaves Sean White, 170 career games played, knocks it through, and the Lions have the lead. 14-3, Butler dancing in the open field, and the Lions dancing in the end zone early in the second.
Yeah, Nathan Rourke making that look easy. Great field position, taking advantage of some careless penalties by the Red Blacks. Capitalizes with his running back, James Butler. He's bouncing back from a hellacious hit last week. And they're going to have a little party in the end zone on Canada Day long weekend. Why not, huh?
They spent a lot of time down in that end zone for the first three games of 2022.
And I asked people what the dance was that they do with their arms going opposite each other, and nobody knows.
They just won't tell us.
None of the coaches were going to give us anything.
Four plays, 55 yards, and let me know if this sounds familiar. A minute 50 on the touchdown drive, same as the first BC touchdown drive, as Terry Williams returns this one across the 35, makes a man miss, and all the way out to the 47-yard line.
Yeah, Jeremiah Mazzoli trying to figure it out. He knows there's a lot of football to be played here, and he's got the horses to do it with, but they haven't really found a rhythm against this defense, BC Lions, that... has really been outstanding the first nine quarters of this season.
Masoli needs 183 yards to pass Jeff Garcia for 46th all-time in passing yardage here tonight. He's got just 21 through the first quarter and a bit. 3 of 8 through the air is the Red Blacks' leading man.
Lost a lot of money on that one because I would have thought he would have been doing a lot better than 21 yards. Can happen in a hurry, though, with him.
Makes the inside run, pressure on, has to just get away. Matthew Betts is in the backfield again.
That's Betts again doing his thing, and it's like they're in Ottawa's offensive huddle. This defense of the BC Lions is just getting her done. He's right here, and then you're going to watch this man scrape, and they've got everybody locked down. That's beautiful. One covering, one pursuing. Where are you going to go? Drill it into the ground.
One of many solid free agency additions from the Lions this offseason, but a little bit of money that's available because you got a guy on a rookie contract right now playing quarterback for you. Masoli, extra protection this time. On second down, it's Betts again. Knocks it away as he gets a knock away, a couple of pressures. He's been in the backfield.
He's like, man, I should have had that. I could have shut off my wheels. Yeah, he's just hanging out here again, and he's going to come up here and just kind of hang out here because he can't get pressure. They're only bringing three, dropping nine. Kind of get bounces right there, gets up, uses his athletic ability. He's probably thinking to himself, that was pick six material.
Ackland tried to get a piece. Richards couldn't get quite enough. Jacob Ruby gave him a nice little pop. And Jeremiah Masoli's 3 of 10 to begin this ball game as the crowd gets a little anxious. With an early 11-point lead for the Lions. They'll get the football back. And Shai Ross takes a tumble at the 20-yard line. The Laval product, third overall pick out of Edmonton. Free agency pickup, working.
Working on my hands.
BC leads 14-3. Nathan Rourke, you know all about it. Most passing yards in a game, as is Jerry DiTillo. And Russ Jackson on that graphic as well. 382 in 1969 is a little crazy. Don Getty with 383 in 1959.
I mean,
Russ is putting in work back in a time where a little bit different. Wasn't throwing it quite as much as some of the passes. Work will load this one up on first down, checks it down underneath. It's complete to Butler, knifes to the sideline, and here's Nathan Rourke in his own words on the connection to Russ Jackson and what it means as a Canadian quarterback.
Obviously, Russ Jackson's a name that I've heard a lot, and for good reason, I'm hoping to be able to, at the end of the day, make an impact similar to him in terms of erasing kind of the uncertainty surrounding a Canadian, can he play the quarterback position, that kind of stuff. I think he did a really good job at that. I think that is the reason why we're still talking about him today. It's an honor to be mentioned the same sentence as him.
Certainly made a strong argument through the first 2 weeks to try and erase some of that narrative as it's incomplete to James Butler here on first down.
Yeah, and dare I say, in that clip there, listening to Nathan talk, he looked like an accountant in the numbers he's putting up. It's just off the chart. And I'll just say that, the demeanor that Nathan Rourke plays the game with and the fire that's inside. I never saw Russ play. I've seen footage. known the man for a long time, and like I stated earlier, as great as he was on the football field, he's even better off, and he's just tremendous, and I think Warwick's made the same.
Well, quick throw that time to the outside, and Sherrod Baltimore read the mail, tried to jump it, knocked away from Lucky Whitehead, incomplete, and the punting unit will come out.
Yeah, just quick slant. Baltimore's running the route for Lucky Whitehead, tries to undercut it, and Whitehead did the right thing, keep going, otherwise it's pick six. That's the closest we've seen in nine plus quarters Nathan Ward throwing an interception.
Punching unit comes out for BC, sends this one away, and it is a dogfight in the middle of the special teams battle here in Ottawa. Terry Williams returns it out across the 30, spins off a man, stays on his feet, and finally has to be escorted by Bo Lucumbo. But not until a solid return for the Red Blacks offense, trying to get the wheels turning with just 3 points on the board here in Ottawa. Jalen Ackland made the trip down the road here to Ottawa with his quarterback Jeremiah Masoli. Oh, what could have been in the Grey Cup with the two of them with more, Matthew Schinetti.
Oh, what could have been exactly, Marshall, because although we take a look at that tip pass for interception that won the Grey Cup for Winnipeg with just a few seconds left in the fourth quarter, there is the pass that is tipped in the end zone. Jalen Ackland had the Grey Cup in his fingertips. I asked him, have you watched it? Yes, I have the confidence, he says, to come back because Jeremiah Masoli wanted me here in Ottawa. We talk about the play all the time, but I know I can get the ball in my hands. And yes, 23 that Jalen Ackland is wearing, that is Michael Jordan. A lot of confidence despite a disappointment, guys.
No doubt. He bounced back in week one, 143 receiving yards, and his 110 a game leads the Canadian Football League right now. He's been impressive, Matty, through the early season.
Yeah, 110 a game, you know, averages out. He's had his woes, like all receivers do. Dropped a deep ball. I think it would have been a 70-yarder, add to that total. But talk about reliable. This guy is money in the bank. He's explosive, and don't sleep on him. He will hurt you.
Matched up here against Gary Peters. It'll be an inside handoff. William Powell on second and short, and it'll be a first down once again for Ottawa. As we reach the midway point of this second quarter and trying to get the wheels turning, as I said before the break, Paul Appelese loves long drives, and he loves the consistency of William Powell being able to extend them.
Yeah, broken play there in first and 10. Jeremiah Masoli flushed out of the pocket briefly, just kind of climbed to his right and found an open receiver and put him a second and medium, a second short. That's exactly what you look for.
Spread it out this time, 3 by 2. Quick rip. That's the return man, Terry Williams, getting his first target of the season. Seen him in the jet sweep game a little bit here in the passing attack, as he's a late substitution for Justin Hardy out with a non-COVID related illness.
Yeah, so point fake to your back here after you establish the line of scrimmage, set your feet, throw a strike right in the hole. Wide receiver reading the zone defense. That's an easy pitch and catch for a veteran quarterback, Jeremiah Masoli. When his feet are right, we know he's got the arm talent to deliver the mail, and he did on that play.
Momentum here with a first down. Beginning a bunch into the boundary. Flying across Masoli's face. Little magic from William Powell through the hole once again. And at that left guard spot, oh man, are they ever happy to have Hunter Stewart back in the lineup moving bodies.
He is just a big boy, just getting her done. Watch him right here. I'll see if I can't get him for you. Watch the big boy get up on him, just squash him. Where'd you go? Whoop, can't see him.
Hey, he got two. He got the most outstanding Canadian and the rookie of the year from last year.
I got this, guys. Just follow me.
Second and short. In comes Caleb Evans, the backup. Oh, well, I'd go behind Hunter Stewart as well after watching that last play, wouldn't you?
Oh, my God. I don't know if you've ever seen Hunter Stewart in person, but you'd be crazy not to. That was about 6'8", 6'9", good 320, 330 in a good day. He's a big boy.
The pride of Bay Ridge Secondary School in Kingston, Ontario. Happy to be back out east after playing for so long with the BC Lions. Ninth year in the league and his first not as a member of the Leos.
I said hello to him before the ball game. I said, hey, Hunter, Matt Dunnigan. He goes, I know who you are. Hunter Stewart. I said, oh, my God. thought I was talking to Miles Burrell or Chris Walby.
Hard count from Masoli on first and 10. Oh, look out. Here comes Boom Guachum trying to extend the play to Masoli. Guachum's going to catch him from behind. Masoli spins away.
Who's out there waiting on him, though?
Olakumbo.
Yeah. Outstanding Canadian player in the CFL last year. We didn't know if he'd be playing tonight. He bounced back from a hellacious collision last week. This is nice. Step outside the tire, out and around, put him in chase mode. Don't think he's going to go away because he's coming. Looked like he's running downhill. Watch him run out of gas. That's, you know, Marshall. You step outside of the tire. It's a technique you learn all the time. You feel the pressure coming backside. You take your right foot, step outside of a tire, pretend like you are, and flip your hips, and you're out and around the gate. And found some time there. Picked up three at least.
And it is Guachum that's down as they're working on what looks like his hamstring. Yeah, that would be a tough loss for the Lions on the D-line, as the big man is a bit of a Willie Jefferson prototype with those long arms and knockdowns and so much potential. We talked to Rick Campbell about second-year players, building around second-year players, investing in them when they were first years last year, hoping they would evolve and improve in this second year, and he's a big part of that core.
Yep, and just carry over, even with James Butler, right? Just carrying over the confidence and knowing what it takes coming into the season now, second year, same system, same coaches, looks like a cramp possibly, and hopefully that's the case because he's walking pretty good.
Kept the motor churning all the way across the field, and so he'll take the slow walk back to the Lions sideline as Rick Campbell back on the sidelines here in Ottawa after, of course, being the first coach in Red Blacks history, 14 through 19, three Grey Cup appearances, including that one right there, 2016.
And yeah, let's go to Sione Tehima. Kid from Keller, Texas. He'll take watching spot.
Masoli on second and long converts it here. That's the first time Ottawa has converted on more than second and five in this ballgame. They were 0 for 5 before that play.
Boy, and that was a nice strike, too. Very confident throw. Had plenty of time. Nice pocket. Watch him work. Nobody in his face. Just stick it in there. That's the way it's supposed to be done.
And here we go, Maddie. This is what matters to Red Blacks coaches, players, and fans. Welcome to the score zone.
Looking for that second touch. Uh-oh, ball goes.
Low snap, trying to pump and look over the top. He'll be knocked away as Marcus Sales was right there against Darvin Adams. But Masoli in the bye week said, we have every opportunity to score. We're getting down the field.
Yeah, what happens here is they're trying to run a fake hit screen. You're going to watch this right here. He's going to fake here. He's going to come out and wheel up here, but Masoli never gets the snap, so he can't get a pump fake in there. And there's the fake. DB's high and over the top. He says, no, not today. I'm just going to bank out here. Knock it down.
Darius Sirocco, free agent addition from Hamilton alongside Ackland. Lorenzo Malden, Masoli, and the rest. It was a low snap last, a little bit low on this one. Flag comes up on the snap, Masoli in trouble. Steps forward in the pocket, jumps, throws, knocked away. TJ Lee right there on the doorstep of the end zone.
Is this going to be holding? Looks like they chased him around. Masoli is able to climb the pocket, and oftentimes when that happens, you know, your tackles, oh, linemen are going to continue to fight and grab a little cloth, and they may have got caught here.
Offside, BC number 20. Holding Ottawa number 65. That'll be a 5-yard difference. Repeat the down.
So it goes back 5 seconds to 15 now from the 21.
And another opportunity for the Red Blacks as they'll take out one of the young draft picks here in Nathan Cherry and substitute in a couple of linebackers on what will be second and 15. Snap coming up from the 21-yard line. Still get a first down, but interesting down and distance here. Three defensive linemen in the game. They'll only rush three. Masoli should have time. Looks over the top. Throws into a window. It's tipped. Jordan Williams right there. knocks it away as Masoli was trying to fit it in.
When you drop nine, those holes get small in a hurry. Just watch what Jeremiah is looking at. Only rushing three. You know he's going to have time. Look at that lane. He's got plenty of time. Tries to fit it in that little window there. Jordan Williams has got great depth here. Oof. About 16, 17 yards of depth. Shows you off his athletic ability and why he was the rookie of the year.
First overall pick. Back in 2020. Had to wait a year to hit the field, but boy, has he ever made an impression.
Our boy, Nathan Rourke.
Lewis Ward knocks it through. Ottawa on the board again. They have six. They wish they had six. Down by eight to the Lions.
The half. The Nathan Rourke show continues. James Butler's playing well. Ooh, Ottawa, a couple weeks off, and this is what we get. And we're going to award the best hairstyle on the panel. It's me.
Well, I mean, it's not much of a contest when I got Matt Dunnigan standing here in the booth with me.
They're talking about the panel, not us.
Inside handoff once again. James Butler, as you heard, off and running into the end zone already this evening. That'll be his fifth carry of the ball game, but less than 10 yards to his name. They really haven't been able to move much up front.
Yeah.
Credit to the Ottawa D-line.
Yep. Benny's got him going. They just can't corral Rourke right now. It's a passing game, and his legs, a lot to contend with. Not bad, though, what I've seen here in the first 28 minutes.
60% of scoring has come in the second and fourth quarter so far this young CFL season. Can the Lions add to it? Pressure, Rourke rolls to his left, right along the sideline. It's completed. Dominique Grimes. Looked a heck of a lot like another smooth completion that was here a couple weeks ago. Kolaros to Ellingson casually along the sideline.
Not a lot of panic. Ice running through those veins right there. Flush to his left. He's going through. Things are getting tight. Just slides beautifully. Cocks his hips and throws a strike moving the chains. It's fun to watch. That's how it's done.
Tight spiral right down the 55. Rourke with pressure on this time, tries to spin away, gets hit from behind and brought down. Just the second sack of the season allowed by a much improved BC offensive line, but that'll cost him and make it second and long.
Yeah, and that's the first type of sack where he's got smothered with the ball in his hands. And yeah, he's right here top of the line, and he's going to eventually get there. Pocket collapses, they bring in six, little twist up front.
First sack of the year for Praise Martin Oguike.
And that's what people wanted to see, how he's gonna respond after that.
Second down and 17, goes underneath, asking Lucky Whitehead to do a lot, he cannot. As that time, it was Randall Evans there to push Whitehead out of bounds.
That's exactly what he's got to do right there. Is just, you can't force what's not there. Can't just magically appear. Take what they give you, dump it down, live to play another play. Defense has been stellar. Take over. See what Flintoff's got here. See if you can't get a directional punt there.
Just on the BC side of midfield, aiming it into the boundary, wobbling spiral, trying to get to the edge is Terry Williams, and he'll turn the corner and be pushed out of bounds at the 25-yard line. Don't miss new episodes of the Emmy-winning series critics call inspired and tremendously entertaining Westworld. An HBO original is now streaming only on Crave.
That's pretty good.
Sci-fi. Ottawa fans craving a little bit of scoring touch here to end
half. I see what you did there, Marshall.
One offensive touchdown in 31 drives, you see there. They're going to have to put some points up at some point if they want to beat this BC club and get their first W of the year.
Plenty of time here. 133. Throws strong here.
Masoli throws it backwards. Yeah, it's caught by Terry Williams. And he dives back, picking up a couple of yards, but that one could have gone sideways real quick.
Yeah, Lee almost got in there, read the mail. Terry Williams showing you Tennessee Martin product is elusive. Nobody's taking him down the first try. We're coming right at you. This ball's actually a lateral. He's right there.
Terry Williams waving blockers. No, just get out in front. Get out in front.
Right? That's confident, right? You got to be cut from a different mold there at block because that is returning kickoffs, punts, and doing that. It gets tough.
Darvin Adams. Wide open, as you say, Matthew. Dunnigan is, he'll move the sticks. Team leading fourth second down conversion for Adams, and the offense will continue to march.
Almost got to think that was some type of bust. He was so wide open. He's right here. Can't miss him. He's 6'4". It's like a bang route sitting in the zone. Got lost.
Dave Bahar playing with an obstacle there. Into the hole it goes.
Ackland.
Jalen Ackland makes the grab, and that will be
his second grab. This is a nice catch, but watch the throw. Ball's out way before he's finished his route. Spots it out there perfectly. And he's a long body, too. 6'2", very lanky. Makes that look easy.
Solely working quickly. Line of scrimmage. Four-man rush. Pressure on. Down it goes. From behind, once again, the Lions get into the backfield. This time, it's Timothy Bonner.
They just keep rolling him out there. Florida Atlantic, second-year player, just continues to motor. I don't know what's going on there, but check it out. He's right here. Number 45, outside move. Sold a little spin move on Stewart. He said, get out of the way, big man. Found his way to Jeremiah Mazzoli's house.
Yeah, the Red Blacks decide to use one of their timeouts right here at the end of the first half.
Wow, that's interesting, right?
Always.
Because it gets stymied here. BC called timeout, got plenty of time on their hands to possibly get points on the move.
So Bonner heads to the sidelines. As in comes the rush package, and Boone Watcham is back on the field.
That's good to see, just a little cramp.
Up at that same three-man line they did.
Yeah, looks like they got a five deep.
On the score zone, Masoli wants to go to his right, tons of time, eventually checks it down underneath to Jalen Ackland. And team defense from the BC Lions. So much discussion about Nathan Rourke, and rightfully so with this offense, but the defense doing their job three straight weeks.
I'm calling time. All right. I'm not letting them run time off the clock.
Ackland adds to his total on the evening and on the season, but it won't help Ottawa get more points here. It's just two field goals to their name now with 32 drives on the season and one touchdown.
Am I missing something here? They had a
just carry it over to the second half. Save that thing in case you need it, I guess.
What?
It's for Campbell's ideology.
What?
Shai Ross will stand back, ready to return.
Nice hit by Richard Leone.
Fly comes down. Ooh, big hit. Right at the point of attack. And again, it's the Red Blacks special teams unit making noise down the field as once again, Dan Bassambombo out of Laval, the first man there on contact.
No yards. Ottawa, number 6. That's a 15-yard penalty. First down.
It's a shame that Pruneau got flagged for it because Bassambombo has been on fire this evening.
Yeah. He's the hammer today, that's for sure. That's the nail. Man. No, thank you. I did not sign up for that. When's the last time you returned punts or kickoffs?
Never.
Never.
Never. Couldn't pay me enough money.
Yeah, we talk about that a lot in the studio. That'll get your motor running when you're back there waiting for those wing nuts trying to take your head off.
That takes a special psychology to put yourself in that situation, and Shai Ross continues to try and fight through the wave of red Canada Day uniforms here in Ottawa as the Red Blacks will have choice to take the ball to start the second half as BC won the toss and took the football. Oh. Rourke will kneel it down. And it's a 14-6 lead for Nathan Rourke and the BC Lions headed to the break here in Ottawa as we send it back to Kate and the panel.
And here, as promised, is the panel. Dava Sanchez, Dave Naylor, Milt Stegall, as the BC Lions continue to roll. And you know, all the questions coming into this game on this panel, how will Nathan Rourke fare on the road, outside for the first time? Dave, so far, so good.
You know, one of the ways Nathan Rourke was described when he was coming into the CFL was he's a gamer. Like, whatever the circumstances is, whether he's having a great day, whether he's not having a great...
14-6, the BC Lions up over the Ottawa Red Blacks as William Powell back in the lineup and down fieldside with Matthew Schinetti.
William, what did you see out of BC's offensive line in the first half?
Their offensive line?
Their defensive line, excuse me.
Okay, there we go. You know, they got a really athletic group, you know, and they showed that athleticism in the day. But we're ready for the challenge, so we're going to just keep fighting and try to get this win.
Is there any worth in establishing the run game in the second half to open up the passing game?
Definitely. It's always worth to establish the run game because, like you said, it'll open up the pass game. So we're going to try to not be one-dimensional and hit them on all cylinders.
And what was Coach LaPolice saying to the offense in the locker room?
We just got to finish drives. We got to put it in the end zone. And if we do that, we'll be all right.
Thanks for this.
All right, thank you.
The yardage isn't where it's been through the first 2 weeks of the Red Blacks season. Jeremiah Masoli completing 50% of his passes, 9 of 18, 83 yards. William Powell, 6 carries, 36 yards. They haven't had many opportunities down inside Lions territory, but when they have, they've come away with 2 field goals. But they will get the football here to begin the second half and try to put an end to this dry spell. 32 drives, just 1 touchdown. Terry Williams gets control across the 30, 35, and will be brought down around the 40. And another big hit on special teams as these two units go back and forth with the big hits.
You do not want to be out there taking those shots. You want to be delivering them, that's for sure. This guy is just, he's impressive. Making a guy miss there. He's just getting it done.
Francis, again, we talked about him earlier. Woods. Oh, it is Josh Woods, you're right. Middle linebackers are all
getting it done.
234 of them.
Yeah, and Francis, how can you miss that guy? 6'6", 250. Yeah, that's what you want. Time to beat on you coming back from the 20 kickoff.
As Masoli gets control, he will hand it off to begin the second half. William Powell. And an inside run that's going absolutely nowhere.
A little pressure.
As it looks like Banks is down. Lacombo asking for some help here for Josh Banks.
Yeah, BC brought a little pressure there, a little run blitz possibly, just controlling a gap. Flush William Powell to his left. I like the thought process. Be aggressive. Don't let them establish that line. Go ahead and dictate to them, and you're going to see Lucas Purefoy come in there.
We get a look here at the end of the play on Josh Banks.
Watch Lucas. Lucas is going to come in here like this, and he's going to force the issue, flushes him, and he's just kind of going around the horn. Mm. He's kind of going around the horn and just kind of fell on top of things. Lacombo made the play, and Powell, Lucas Purefoy, flushed him. He's up and running. He's good.
We'll make some substitutions. The backup is someone who the Lions really seem to enjoy his production in the early season for the limited reps that he's been getting. And Thibaut Dubai with a Towson, another second-year player on the defensive line. So he'll get a bit of a look here as they roll through the likes of Nathan Cherry, Riley Pickett.
Yeah, they got like 9 of them dressed. I'm like, they're going to run out.
Pressure coming up front on second and show. No, over the top. Masoli had no chance that time. The pressure was on immediately, and it's a 2 and out to begin.
That was jailhouse. That was just everybody. They just come rolling off the edge. Watch them. They're all coming. And Jeremiah, it's a good job of not roughing the quarterback here. You know, just flush him, make him throw it up his back foot. That's good, 2 and out.
Team defense for the Lions.
Aggressive defense, right? Oh, yeah. Pressure on the run and pressure on the pass, too.
Ryan Phillips loves it, and so does Nathan Rourke. The return turn right up the middle. Antoine Pruneau makes the tackle. Flag is out. As it looks like it'll be no yards again. A lot of those here this evening.
Yeah. We'll figure it out. Look at Nathan's first half numbers.
During the return, holding BC number 18. 10-yard penalty, first down, BC.
Check him. He showed you flashes, right? Mm-hmm. This is a pretty good flash right here. You talk about them fireworks off the top? Ooh-wee, 50 yards in the end zone. Corner route. This is just weeding out the weak link there in coverage, and Avery Williams, and he saw him and cut him out of the herd, and easy pitch and catch for his running back, James Butler, for the first score, and then our second score.
A very disappointing 68.8 completion percentage in this first half. Rourke really flying back down to earth.
It's a different language when you're talking like that.
Inside handoff to begin for the Lions here. But really, he set such an exceptional standard through the first two games of this season that he's completing almost 70% of his passes, and it kind of feels ho-hum.
Yeah, it kind of did. But ho-hum against this defense, you got to check yourself. He still got it done and put two scores on the board. This is important second and seven right here. Both offenses trying to establish the line of scrimmage. Right there, you saw the Lions coming back. Respect for their defense of the Ottawa Red Blacks. Trying to establish the run to give the quarterback possibly a little more time. Didn't make it happen. Second and long here. He's been exceptional in this area right here as well.
Record for completion percentage over two games. Will he get the ball away? Here he will. It's intercepted. First of the year. Money Hunter gets his second interception of the year. Stays on his feet. Cuts back. And gets wrapped up from behind. It's Lucky Whitehead. But finally, Ottawa gets a turnover and gets it right down inside the score zone. Can they convert it and get some points on the board? Money Hunter cashing checks as Rourke pressure on, tipped at the line, and Money makes some. Red Blacks with a real opportunity to change this game when we return to Thursday Night Football.
Yeah, and I think the intended receiver, and I specify think, and he's sitting around this area right here. And when our pocket collapses, you're going to see him step up and avoid the initial rush on the outside, climbs the pocket right there. Then he gets tangled, and he's trying to find Pearson, I believe. And knocked off balance, and the ball comes up. First interception of the year. Second for Money Hunter, eighth of his career.
Jeremiah Masoli running on a quarterback draw through the tackles. Nice pickup that time, making a few Lions misses. Yeah, Rourke's first interception on his 91st pass attempt of this season, but that is exactly what the doctor ordered for a Red Blacks offense that needs dearly to add some points.
Yes, no question. Take that all day. That's what good defenses do, turn the ball over and give their offense a chance. And Jeremiah's got to capitalize with six here on second and three.
We'll break Jalen Acklin out to his right-hand side. No touchdowns for Acklin on the season, despite his stellar yardage. Pressure up front, they'll hand it off. William Powell banging between the tackles. He'll pick up the first down.
Yeah, he got four, just a nice off-tackle play. Just recumbering Williams, Hunter Stewart, mauling people. Just watch him get after it. Downhill, just go get it. Make a hole if you have to. Move the sticks.
Personnel change, Darvin Adams out. Anthony Gosselin, the fullback, will check into the ball game. A little bit of a heavier look here. As Gosselin will line up as a tight end. Masoli under center.
Got a goal line stance against Toronto last week. So he can get one here. Oh, nice little
pitch
play.
To the outside. Powell spinning back off tackles. Touchdown, Red Blacks, as Willie P back in the nation's capital and back in the end zone. Been too long since the wood cookie's been cut here at TD Place. You can feel the release of energy from the crowd as William Powell crossed the goal line.
Sweet little play call, little fly sweeps, fake, and then dish it out to Wipo. Little spin and extra effort. That's what he's going to give you every time. Veteran running back finding the end zone. Beautiful.
And they'll go for two here to try and knot this one up at 14 apiece. Marco Dubois, another one of these fullbacks in the ball game. As he'll line up in the same tight end spot. From the 3-yard line this time, it's Acklin to the right of Masoli. Will they go back to the run game? They will. Powell banging between the tackles. Flag comes up, but he is in for now with the 2-point conversion. And the Lions believe it's against Ottawa.
Yeah, this is going to play big.
If it is, it'll back them up and they'll.
Illegal formation. Let's see what we got. Oh, yeah.
Paul LaPolice wants an explanation. Here's Dave Foxcroft.
Procedure, Ottawa, no end. It's a 5-yard penalty. Retry the convert.
We get a look at the formation here and see what the alignment was, Matty. What the problem was. Was somebody not on the line? Too many on the line?
I can see Lapo mouthing. He didn't get down? He didn't get down? Hmm. He didn't get down? He wanted an explanation. Knew exactly what the problem was. Probably been working on it all week, the last couple weeks.
Well, those 2-point calls are premeditated to the max.
Yes, they are. Some you work to perfection. Now they're going to go for it from the 8.
Apple's not backing down. Not many opportunities to add points on the board for Ottawa tonight from this close. A fire from the right hash. Fullbacks are out. Receivers are in. 5 of them available for Masoli. He'll step up in the pocket. Lobs it to the back of the end zone. It's incomplete, but a flag is out. Nate Bahar saying that he had Quincy Moje out of Georgia give him a little tug on the backside of the uniform.
Defensive pass interference, BC number 36. Ball will be placed on the 1-yard line. We'll retry the convert.
And in come the heavies for both sides.
Yeah, I believe he's right here. He's going to be right behind the goalpost as we let this roll a little bit. We'll see him. Number. Right there. That's on Lucas Purifoy.
Yeah, that's Purifoy.
That's Purifoy.
You can see the smile coming from Moje after the flight came out. But here we go.
Not much, but it's enough to be called to impede his progress to the ball. So here
third time to try. Caleb Evans is in. He'll sneak it forward. Well, we had a procedure call. Move it back. Pass interference. Move it forward. Caleb Evans in. Put it in the end zone. Tied up at 14, the Red Blacks get an interception off Kick Canada. Masoli cashes in. William Powell doing the dirty work on Canada Day, long weekend in the nation's capital.
Yeah, Money Hunter, halfback, corner for the Red Blacks. Won't get an easier one than this. Second of the season, eighth of his career. Just gifted, and poor decision by the young quarterback. And here, nice little play call, pitch out to Wipo. William Powell, little spin move. And then Caleb Evans, after a couple penalties, seated him at the 1-yard line. Easy plunge there, following the big boys. All tied up, 14.
The Red Blacks finally cash in down near the end zone as Purifoy will get wrapped up on the return. Before that trip, they had 7 on the season, 4 field goals, 2 turnovers on downs, and just the 1 touchdown. They've added another, and they've got this game at 14. Here with 10 minutes left in the third.
And I'm not so sure about that Purifoy PI. But water under the bridge. Count it. We're all tied up. See how the young quarterback responds, right? When I was talking to Russ Jackson, guy we're talking about a lot because he's the best. That play has been the benchmark for decades. We wanted to see this young quarterback in a pressure situation. Well, he's in one now.
Energy back in the building here. Shaq Johnson wants the fans on their feet. Rourke rolls to his left, forced to rip it to the sideline. It's complete. And it will go to Keon Hatcher on the outside as he answers after the interception with pressure on and make a throw.
Interesting, because he was coming to his left, and then he kind of tried to square his feet to make that throw as opposed to continuing on the run and pressing the edge. He threw a strike there. Had a lot of zip, got there, moving chains.
Wanders around the pocket, communicates with the backfield here in James Butler. Once again, pressure from that wide side. Gets the ball out quickly. And Hatcher taking a more key role in this offense with Brian Burnham down and out. A punctured lung, broken ribs. Unfortunate for the lead man in this receiving group last couple of seasons. Four times straight as an all-star in the CFL.
Yeah, he'll fast, Brian. And Hatcher, as you mentioned, he dropped an 8 from his number. He went from 84 to 4. Makes him look faster and skinnier.
Well, a Darius Bowman body type there wearing number 4.
Talking to Jason Tucker, the receiver coach, before the ball game at length. He had all good things to say about Hatcher.
Second down and 5. Ripping it hard as he could. Dunningan wants a flag. So does Lucky Whitehead. The BC Lions O-line was looking for it.
Yeah, we'll take a look at Lucky here on this little quick slant. Oh, no, a little bang move was sweet. Oh, that was played really well. I thought that was PI initially, but that was played really well. I don't know.
That's a good contested rep. Oh, and a challenge flag looks like has come out from Rick Campbell.
Yeah.
Just before they got the snap away. Rick got the word from upstairs. We might want to take a look at this one. And he is one of two on the season, one of only three coaches to have a successful challenge out of 13 total across the league to begin this season.
Only three have got it right.
BC's challenging that there was defensive pass interference against their number 7.
Yeah, right.
We'll review the play.
So Randy Teata from Texas Christian, second-year player. Did he get his hand in there or not?
Get a quick look at it here. Too much contact or a great defensive play? You be the judge. We'll get the verdict when we return to Thursday Night Football.
Across the country, businesses have had to adjust how they operate and make difficult decisions to protect their employees, customers, and communities. While we don't yet fully know where this road will lead, we do know you don't have to walk it alone. When you're ready, Cox Media's team of experts will be here to offer thoughtful perspective on messaging and media planning as your customers are evolving how they watch, read, and connect. We're here to help you navigate this together. Cox Media. Better together.
A new Chevy is the smart way to hit the open road this summer. The smart way to road trip and seek new adventures. Go a little farther this summer in a new Chevy. Find new get up and go, find new roads. Enjoy the open road and make no monthly payments for the rest of summer on all 2022 Silverado 1500 pickups. Plus, get 2.49% financing when you finance with GM Financial. Find new roads at your local Chevy dealer.
Early round coverage at Wimbledon continues tomorrow as some of the biggest names in tennis take to the grass courts for day 5 action. Tune in at 6 a.m. Eastern, 3 a.m. Pacific. I know you'll be up, Lions fans, only on TSN. Claire Hanna enjoying her time at Wimbledon as we head down to Dave Foxcroft with the announcement here on the challenge decision. Pass interference or not?
After review, we have defensive pass interference, Ottawa number 16. That'll be a 10-yard penalty, first down, BC.
Well, if they got Luchez Purifoy down here on the two-point.
Which was ticky-tack.
Then down here, after review, a bang-bang play goes against the Red Blacks.
I think they had his right arm in there, pulling him around before the ball got there. Pretty tough to see. But my thing was, Rick Campbell, head coach of the Lions, he challenged it, but he had his punt team on the field, never put his offense out there. If I'm challenging, I'm trying to get good vibes going, right? And putting the old
keep
out there.
Keep that offense out there.
Right?
Well, they do return to the field rather quickly after the decision. Nathan Rourke gets an extra possession thanks to the successful challenge, just the fourth of 2022, as James Butler gets wrapped up after a gain of 2.
Nothing. It's just outstanding defensive play. I think that's Lorenzo Malden. Just watch him play in the end here. Just stop standing up, and it comes off of it and folds off of it. And it is Malden just getting the job done there. Making an edge, standing tall, coming off the block, shedding the blocker, making a tackle for a 1 yard, 2 yard gain.
Pressure's on here. Full blitz, man everywhere. Outside intercepted. Money Hunter. Can he get a house call or will Rourke catch him? Down the sideline. And Rourke did the job, but his second interception of the ball game, second of the second half, once again sets up the Red Blacks deep in Lions territory.
Yeah, this is a jailbreak. They're bringing the house and betting that what you heard, Benny, Mike Benavides, defensive coordinator, camping out on all the different possibilities, and Money Hunter's on fire. He's got some fireworks of his own, responding with almost a pick six there. We'll turn the ball all the way down. Top of your screen, we'll watch this play here. Money Hunter's gonna jump this. He knows pressure's coming. He's gotta get rid of it. Never gets out of his back pedal. Sees the play right in front of him, inside out. Rourke gets the angle on, taking him out at the center.
And Masoli comes out with another opportunity, this time to take the lead, not to tie. Shows inside run. Masoli will keep it himself. To the outside, cutting back. Bolakombo drags down Masoli from behind. Went down hard, pops up onto his feet, he'll get his shoulder pad fixed up, and back to the line of scrimmage, but a tough run from Masoli.
Yeah, this is, he's getting on his horse the whole time here. Well, he had the edge quickly. Combo peeled off and made the tackle.
Right back up under center. Masoli leads to his left, turns the feet. Ottawa has the lead as the Canada Day fireworks go off.
Yeah, this is just, we want a little bit more. Had a big stop down here in the goal line at BC Place last week against the Argos. Not here against the Red Blacks as they've seized momentum here in the third quarter and taken the lead. First time I believe the Lions have been playing from behind.
Well, something had to give. You knew this Red Blacks team was better than 0-2 after fighting tough with the Winnipeg Blue Bombers for the first two games of the season. BC absolutely on fire offensively through the first two games of their season as the extra point is missed by Lewis Ward. Now you've got Rourke with a couple of interceptions. The offense comes alive for the Ottawa Red Blacks. That means a 2014 lead. Soli looking for some love.
There it is.
Finding it on the long weekend.
Across the country, businesses have had to adjust how they operate and make difficult decisions to protect their employees, customers, and communities. While we don't yet fully know where this road will lead, we do know you don't have to walk it alone. When you're ready, Cox Media's team of experts will be here to offer thoughtful perspective on messaging and media planning as your customers are evolving how they watch, read, and connect. We're here to help you navigate this together. Cox Media. Better together.
A new Chevy is the smart way to hit the open road this summer. The smart way to road trip and seek new adventures. Go a little farther this summer in a new Chevy. Find new get up and go, find new roads. Enjoy the open road and make no monthly payments for the rest of summer on all 2022 Silverado 1500 pickups. Plus, get 2.49% financing when you finance with GM Financial. Find new roads at your local Chevy dealer.
Got to come out with the football rush. He's going to take a sack. He jumps it. He's got a second of the night. Cherry picking the young quarterback. Man, that's good defense.
Oh, and as fast as Nathan Rourke ran on his 50-yard touchdown run earlier, he picked up and put him down pretty good to go chase down Money Hunter. Always the wise decision, as you know, Matt, as the quarterback, to take the angle as well. Don't cut that thing short. Let's aim for the pylon, and we'll meet him when we meet him, right?
Yeah. I remember my first year backing up Warren Moon. He'd throw a ball in practice to the wide side. He used to start jogging over there, and I'm going, finally, I had, you know, got the courage enough to talk to him. Mr. Moon, what are you doing? And he goes, well, man, it's a long ways over there. I'm just getting a head start in case he comes back the other way. And that was solid advice because I served up my share of picks over the years. And right now, that young man's got to regroup in a hurry because the Red Blacks have stolen his mojo.
Well, I'll say this. If you tuned in because you love the Nathan Rourke story, ain't nothing wrong with a little adversity.
That's right.
Add a little bit of intrigue to the story of the young Canadian quarterback. As we see how he'll battle back into this one, now trailing for the first time this season.
It's exactly what we wanted to see. Not that we want to see his success come to an end, just want to see him face this defense of the Red Blacks, what Benavides has done, what he's able to get done over 2 weeks, having an off week. A little adversity here for the young quarterback, see how he responds. Russ Jackson, you got what you're looking for.
And here comes the crowd noise. Rourke in the gun. Hands it off inside. James Butler driving the feed in the first solid gain on first down with the back.
Yeah, I really think that Rourke could have kept that. And if you just look at it here, what he's reading, he's looking at the end, right over here, coming this way. Now he had two plus there. He did the right thing. Coming high. That's why Butler was able to pick up almost seven. Yeah, they're not messing around. There's Jordan McSimmick. They're not messing around at all with Nathan Rourke and his running ability because they had two coming up high there. They had Mornogueke coming around. They had somebody crashing in the inside hole as well, so they had both holes, one on the outside, one on the inside covered.
As Praise Martin Aguike checks out of the ball game, past two throws on second down have been interceptions. BC has not run the ball on second down. Rourke will line up in the gun here and send Javon Katoy and Dominique Grimes in motion. Four receivers to his right. Preston. That's where he'll look.
Pressure on it.
Bust. Open. Down the field. Keon Hatcher. Countdown on. 30, 20, 10. Touchdown Lions. Stood in against the pressure and delivers a dime, but a busted coverage for the Red Blacks defense.
Penny's trying to figure it out on the fly. Nathan Rourke did. He says, you do that, we're going to send somebody to the hole, which you have to do. You just can't feed it outside. Boy, he stood in there, took one on the ribs in a chase position in a hurry. Ooh-wee. How about that for facing adversity?
Staring down the barrel and making a throw, albeit to a wide open receiver, as Justin Howell, the free safety, was the one closest. Coming back early off the six-game injured list with a hamstring he was dealing with through the early part of the season. And the interesting point here becomes Lewis Ward missed the extra point on that last Red Blacks touchdown. And so with Sean White knocking it through the uprights, it's a lead for the Lions.
Mama, John, I know what it is. Daddy, thank you. Grandma, you better.
Yeah, this is what you're going to see. You're going to see coming out here, he's going to go to the hole. Nobody takes him, and he's here, and they're all going to sit on this. And it's got, I thought you had him. I thought you had him. Meanwhile, it's a rib fest of Nathan Rourke's ribs, and he spots the ball up there beautifully. It's all you got to do is lay it out there. Well, that's pretty. That's the way you respond. Yeah, this is what Nathan Rourke's staring at. You got to keep your eyes right here and focused. And everybody's coming here, folks. Just watch them. You got eight in the box, and they're coming off the edge as well. Oh. Smart play. Not lighting him up there.
Tell you what, Matty, you know this as well as anybody. It's not great to get hit, but watching your teammate score a touchdown walking in while you're on your back is a pretty damn nothing, good feeling.
Nothing better than that. Standing tall, doing your job, feeding the rock to the receiver, letting him do the work. Yeah, It's a great feeling. That's what it's all about.
As Williams runs into his own man that time, downfield, flying in on special teams was Hakeem Johnson. It is a battle out there on every punt, every kickoff, even field goal. We saw some misconduct penalties earlier.
I love the way our producer, John Hines.
Illegal block, Ottawa number 6. 10-yard penalty, first down.
The second flag on Antoine Pruneau.
Has described special teams play tonight. It is a barroom brawl out there, and it is nasty. And chairs are flying. Cocktails everywhere. People screaming, jukeboxes going off. Yeah, that's what pretty much what it's like. And it takes a different athlete to go out there and do that consistently. Run down on special teams, blocking, covering, returning. That's just chaos.
Back and forth we go. Ottawa's had a couple of short fields. Now they get a long one from their own 16. Show inside run, flip it out, incomplete. Off the hands of Nate Behar. Yeah. And it'll set up second and long.
I think he might have been peeking up on defender coming down front of this so-called blocker. Took his eyes off that ball. Nate Behar showing some toughness this year, making a lot of contested catches across the middle, first down catches, becoming extremely valuable and developing a good rapport with Jeremiah Masoli.
40% of his yardage this season has come after the catch.
Yep.
Leads the Ottawa Redblacks in that category. Catching it, making the most of it, but couldn't that time. It leaves second and 10. Draw a little handoff here in between the tackles. Looking for daylight goes William Powell. And the BC defense does their job. Ottawa will have to send it away.
Immediately Delvin Bros playing corner, as we all know. Throws up his hand, knows that they got stopped, got off the field. It's huge momentum now. BC gets getting some good field position here.
Shy Ross looking for a little direction here. He's had a busy evening.
Hey, north-south, Shy. North-south.
Coach, return left, return. No, return right up the middle.
Yeah, north-south. Get what you can.
Sends it to the sideline. Beautiful directional punting. Keeps it in bounds. And the coverage unit does their job.
Not much you can say about that. That's a nice catch.
Breaks a tackle. He's still going. Across midfield and more.
He's got some wheels. Phil Pop's got some wheels.
That's awesome.
Christian Matt loves it for the Montreal Alouettes awesome. As they get the rematch coming up against the Saskatchewan Roughriders. But don't miss next week's CFL Wired episode, bringing you exclusive access to the latest CFL highlights. Catch it Wednesday, 7:30 Eastern, 4:30 Pacific, only on TSN.
Love that show. It takes you right down there, shows you what it's all about. What makes the game fun is the interaction on the field, just verbiage, everything. Now, this is what I want to see. Second and medium. How's Benny going to handle things here? How's the young quarterback going to handle things here? We've seen how it's played out in the last two series. Interception and then a touchdown.
Beated him up last time. It was a bust. Rourke made him pay. This time a four-man rush. He pumps, looks to the outside, throws a laser beam for a completion and a first down.
He and Hatch got something going on right now. He's looking pretty sweet in that four, looking mighty fast. Coming right at you. Watch him go through his progressions here. This is not his first read.
Pump.
Stack it. That's what I miss about the game. Just slinging it right there. Just putting, you know, just it's making those throws.
In the Canadian Football League, man, I don't have to tell you, but you get about 10 to 12 throws a game that can decide a game on second down. That's one of them. And Rourke throws a heater that time. To move the sticks. Gets another opportunity here. Stands tall in the pocket. Time running out. Here come the wheels. Cutting it back. Looking for room. And he makes two men miss. And he'll get a first down with his legs.
Oh, I this is good stuff. This is more fireworks here. You know, he's pulling it down and make things happen. He stays in there as long as he can. You got Lang right in his face. Climbs the pocket. Makes a guy miss. Ball security. Picks up the first down.
Looking like Matthew Dunnigan on a Canada Day long weekend at the cottage when the music's just right. Just dancing, good. Moving through the crowd.
A few beverages, you know, just playing with the kids.
All right.
Yeah.
Lorenzo Malden, the injured Ottawa Red Black.
And we'll go back and look at Rourke. Throw each throw he just made. Just darting a nice out route here to Hatcher. Moving the sticks, and this going back to the first quarter, both you and I were had our jaws dropping. The corner route, tight coverage.
I'm jealous of Shinetti down there on the sideline with the perfect angle of watching that one drop down.
He had going at it.
Rourke's got 308 yards of total offense, 74 on the ground, 234 through the air. Butler adds to his tally here on first down with a nice gain of six.
Man, he pressed the hole, nothing there. Then he started going lateral, which is scary. But then he found a little seam, turned on the jets, and picked up six. Watch this. This is beautiful. This is good running here. Press the hole at you. Press it, press it. Nothing there. Lateral, lateral, lateral. Oh, I got to get vertical. There we go.
Sets up another second down and four. Rourke, four options to his right. Finds Butler again in the flats. Patrick levels one-on-one. Makes the miss the first time. Butler dances away through two more tackles. Down inside the five-yard line, reminiscent of his explosive week one performance against the Edmonton Elks.
Yeah, just incredible first week. He's right here. Just going to slip out here. Ball. Watch where the ball's placed. And I think this is what impresses me a lot about this quarterback. On the money, gives a chance, the running back an opportunity, levels as in space and brings it down to the 5-yard line. Easy flat throw turns into big money. First and goal on top.
Inside handoff. Butler looking for the edge. Walk breaks contain, walk it in. Touchdown Lions as they'll extend their lead at the end of the third.
Wow. Six touchdown on the year. Just a walk in right about here. James is excited. He knows it. Oh, I like the play call. I like what they did in the design. Doesn't look like much, but on the front side, they did a lot for the Red Blacks to think about, bringing an extra receiver in, widening the edge for Nathan Rourke in case he wanted to pull it. Red Blacks had a spy there. Nathan gives it to Butler. Easy walk-in score. Big response from the young quarterback here late in the third quarter.
Two interceptions thrown. Comes back, busted coverage. Finds Hatcher on a long touchdown.
Pulls one down himself, makes a couple of sweet throws. And lets his teammates do the rest. It's not all about him. He's got a lot of help out there.
No doubt. Six plays, 60 yards, 3 minutes and 9 seconds on the touchdown drive.
Coming right at you. Where's the Butler? There he is.
As Keon Hatcher gets just enough. Why not dance on a Canada Day long weekend?
Oh my God.
Nailed the dismount. Lions by 8.
Across the country, businesses have had to adjust how they operate and make difficult decisions to protect their employees, customers, and communities. While we don't yet fully know where this road will lead, we do know you don't have to walk it alone. When you're ready, Cox Media's team of experts will be here to offer thoughtful perspective on messaging and media planning as your customers are evolving how they watch, read, and connect. We're here to help you navigate this together. Cox Media. Better together.
A new Chevy is the smart way to hit the open road this summer. The smart way to road trip and seek new adventures. Go a little farther this summer in a new Chevy. Find new get up and go, find new roads. Enjoy the open road and make no monthly payments for the rest of summer on all 2022 Silverado 1500 pickups. Plus, get 2.49% financing when you finance with GM Financial. Find new roads at your local Chevy dealer.
The BC Lions lead by 8 after the third quarter, as you see 254 passing yards. Nathan Rourke having to go through some adversity, a couple of poor decisions, one inaccurate throw forced by the solid defense of the Red Blacks. But back he comes, trying to find a way to win on the road for the first time in his young career.
Yeah, 5 of 7 for 118 yards in that third quarter alone. Two interceptions, but he bounced back in a big way, guiding his team twice to the end zone himself and righting the ship. Hey, nod to the defense of the BC Lions, put in a tough spot. And Nathan Rourke found a way to say, sorry, guys, we're going to get this lead back for you, see if we can't keep it here in the fourth.
Antonio Pipkin just said, hey, we're just trying to break some stuff down here, man. As Rourke goes to work with Jason Tucker, the receivers coach on that sideline, Pipkin the third stringer. Stephen Flintoff, haven't said his name much because there's been some turnovers, some touchdowns, a couple field goals. Hasn't been active on the punting game, but gets the kickoff away here, and it's dropped down just outside the 30-yard line.
Jeremiah Masoli held to, what, 80-plus yards in that in the first three quarters, 86?
9 of 20 right now for 83 yards.
83? That's, this guy, we all know that he was just 160-something shy of moving into 46 all-time in front of Jeff Garcia. And, you thought he would have had that in a quarter.
0 of 2 in that third quarter. Only two attempts from Masoli. They couldn't stay on the field long enough.
To his credit, he did it with his legs as well, right?
Short fields, they took advantage. Knotted this game up, and the Lions have answered. Now it's Ottawa's turn. Stacked up on first down as Quincy Mojé comes down from free safety alongside Jordan Williams, the middle linebacker.
Yeah, I'm gonna say that was more Jordan Williams. Mm-hmm. That was just, one second you've got William Powell coming downhill, and then boom. A second later, he's not going anywhere because Williams is there.
92 defensive tackles and a sack last year.
Rookie had to wait around. He drafted in 2020. Along with Rourke, right? These two guys are just chomping at the bit, show their skill set.
As is Masoli here in Ottawa, gets it away, but they're in perfect coverage as Marcus Sales on Terry Williams.
Yeah, love me some Sales. That guy's smooth, makes it look pretty easy. Spent a couple seasons with Winnipeg. And he's not very big, but boy, he is smart and he is well positioned and he's got great instincts and he is all over that receiver, forcing third and two.
Masoli completes just his 10th ball of the ball game. Still shy of 100 yards. Couldn't have predicted that. 700 yards combined through the first two games. But BC will get the football back once again as the time of possession here starts to lean towards BC in the second half.
Nice hit.
Shai Ross gets wrapped up, and if you love the player wearing number 12 for the BC Lions, wait until you hear his head coach Rick Campbell on the person.
He's a guy that is very steady, very grounded. I've said about him, and I mean this as a huge compliment, is I think his self-worth doesn't come from being a good football player. That doesn't mean he's not driven and that he loves the game, all those things, but I think the guys that can differentiate between the two are have a healthy mindset, and I think life is bigger than football for him.
Certainly means a lot to him. But a life-work balance, a big part of Rourke's attack as they go with the throwback screen this time to Butler. Open field in front of him as Philip Norman gets down, and a gain of 15 to open things up on first down, and Jordan McSimmick opens up the playbook for the first time.
Yeah, I could see that one coming, and I guarantee it, Jordan McSimmick thought they were going to get more out of that, but that was just good defense by the Red Blacks of rallying. Watch as Rourke, he just goes out there, gains depth, more depth, comes back, and floats one out to Butler. Good pursuit. Inside out by Red Blacks. Minimal gain. About 219.
Working the gun on first down, hands it off to Butler, and the defensive line is there once again from Ottawa. But I'll tell you, on that last play, Matty, we're hearing from Rick Campbell about how grounded he is. You got to be pretty calm and grounded to roll to your right, gain some depth, throw it back across your body. All these bodies flowing in strange directions requires a little bit of discipline to get that one out, albeit an easy completion, no doubt, but the process of getting there.
You know those are fun. And, you know, you can't wait for the coach to call that play and go out there and execute it, and they did a nice job of it. Tip of the hat to the Red Blacks for sniffing it out and keeping it to a minimal game.
Goes backwards from second and 12 here. Rourke loads it up, checks it down underneath. There's the big body of Javon Kotoy.
There you go,
Javon. Haven't
said
his name much this evening. 10 catches coming in.
Just yeah, that's one. North-south, big boy. Talking Jason Tucker, I was asking, what about Kotoy? What a big body he is. He really is. He says, and Matty, he's always looking for contact. He's seeking it out. Catches it, secures the rock. Takes two to get him down.
One of those guys that when you stand field side pregame, he walks past and you go, wow, I knew you were big.
You have no idea, right? That's a big receiver at 6'5", 235.
Lots of options for Rourke in this offense. He's distributed it well. He'll keep it this time. Oh, makes the man miss. Right in the hole. Rourke dancing away. Now it's out. Fumbles out. Last touch by the Red Blacks. And Money Hunter will get credit for it. As it was punched out from behind, Rourke was dancing his way through the red and black uniforms. But a third turnover of the ball game for the Lions' leading man.
Yep. Going to have to lean on his defense one more time.
Justin Howell got a look at it, cuts it back. North-south, head to the sideline. Howell back off the injured list, says, give me that. Money Hunter with the tap. Red Blacks football when we return. Just one fumble lost coming into tonight for the BC Lions. They lose one here. Ottawa down eight with possession of the football. As Jeremiah Masoli has time to his right. Throws it back to his left. Darvin Adams, can he find him? Holds it in at the 35.
Wow, that was a play that took a lot of time to develop, but I believe it was designed. And you're going to watch Jeremiah Masoli work to his right, play fake, steps up, pulls the defense, and then just flick of the wrist over the top to Adams. He ran a beautiful route.
Low snap this time as they go quickly to the line of scrimmage and rolls into the feet of Masoli. They had something dialed up there as well, Matty. There were four receivers to a bunch. Unusual formation for the Red Blacks. Couldn't take advantage of it thanks to the snap.
Yeah, and we saw that at least three times in the previous quarter. That wasn't even close. Here's, watch Adams. And this is what I'm talking about, slow developing. He looks like he can run a post here. Then he, bam, instinctively just flips his hips, goes and makes a tough catch look routine.
Longest gain of the ball game is that Darvin Adams catch. Help them cross midfield. Masoli will check it down. Underneath, William Powell getting involved in the passing attack to the 30-yard line. And on second down and long, after another drive just killed by an unfortunate error, they try to gain some yardage back, but it's Lewis Ward that makes his way off the sideline. And Paul Lapolis won't like that one in film.
Marshall, you and I were talking about it here in the third quarter. We saw that shotgun snaps were difficult on Masoli down inside the red zone. They were getting back to him by his ankles, and we saw that one didn't even make it back there.
So Lewis Ward will line this up from 37, 38 yards away. Boulder's Richie Leone missed an extra point earlier, hammers this one through, closes the gap 28-23. In a battle in week four to kick off Canada Day long weekend, and a shot up high from Josh Banks. Masoli will get it back. Third round coverage of the John Deere Classic gets underway Saturday as golfers tee off from the bentgrass greens at TPC Deer Run. Catch the action. 3 Eastern, 1 Pacific only on TSN. fans enjoying a back-and-forth battle here this evening. Nathan Rourke, some self-inflicted wounds. Matt Dunnigan, but back out with a first and 10 from his own 40. You and I were just talking during the break. Why is this a ball game? Why is this a five-point lead for the BC Lions when it could be more?
Yeah, well, I'll give credit to Mike Benavidez's defense. Money Hunter, well-executed defensive scheme, pressure, sit on it, jump it, make it count. And Nathan Rourke, poor decision after pressure, climbing the pocket, throws the ball he shouldn't have. And then running carelessly with the ball, being punched out. So 17 points off of turnovers, and Red Blacks are right back in it, just 5 points behind.
Snap comes up to Rourke on second down, rifles it in to Dominique Rimes. As that field, and a late flag comes out as well, as that field goal that was made by Lewis Ward was the first points of the season given up by the Lions in a fourth quarter.
Is that helmet to helmet?
I don't think so.
Avery Williams doesn't think so, but it was a tough catch in traffic. I didn't see a helmet to helmet. Take a look at it. Right to left. Oh, man. Yeah, it could have been right there. And you saw Dominic take the brunt of that helmet to helmet shot. Avery didn't like it.
Regardless, it was going to move the sticks with another completion by Rourke on second, but yeah, it will give a big chunk of yardage.
Tough catch made by Dominic Rimes, who's got a
major
bunch
foul,
of
unnecessary roughness. Ottawa, number 46, 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
That's Williams at 42 that had it. As we get the super slow-mo look here to try and figure out the point of contact.
Yeah, let's check it out.
Rourke goes back to work with a handoff to Butler. Dances his way through the line of scrimmage and picks up a gain of about 11. It'll move the sticks once again. And BC in control as we pass the halfway point in the fourth.
Yeah, he's listening to Rick Campbell talk about what they saw in him, saying that if he can take what he was doing the last 4 weeks, the last season into this season, he'll be something special. And you saw him making some really timely moves, picking up a first down there, making it look relatively easy.
Fresh set of downs, first and 10. Butler, inside handoff, into the pile he goes. And it's
into the fray one more time. That to me, I mean, one carry, you're out in the middle of the field, nobody around you. Next carry, you're attracting flies everywhere.
Tell you what, the averages are not going to be pretty by the end of this one, but they're certainly trying to stick to the running game both sides.
You have
as
to.
Butler's got 14 carries for 48 yards. Powell, 11 for 55. Very similar. Punching it into the middle of that defensive line on both sides. But Rourke lines up here with second and seven. Play clock down. Quick steps up in the pocket. Makes the man miss. Looks out to his right and incomplete. Had Javon Katoy, and it would have been enough for the first down.
Yeah, he wanted to go left, and they had tight coverage there, so he pulled it down, and then he was going to run. Then he said, no, I still got the line of scrimmage, I'm going to try to throw it. And he does. There he goes. Now he's thinking about it. We saw that happen to him in week one after his long 33-yard run. Stepped out of bounds at about the 7, 8, or 9-yard line. Next play, rolled to his right and skipped one in front of the end zone. I asked him about it. He says, I felt like I was out of shape and I was huffing and puffing and I was out of breath. That's why that happened. I kind of think something like that happened right there.
Yeah, it looks like he's feeling it a little bit, as that was his first incompletion since the last interception. Two of them in this ball game. Frankie Griffin, the injured Red Black, down on the field getting attention. But after the second interception thrown, and actually there's two Red Blacks down on the field, Rourke is 7 of 8, 149 yards, and the touchdown.
And this is important field goal here, obviously, make it 31-23, an 8-point game. Response after you gave the Red Blacks another opportunity to put points on the board last series.
And we get another opportunity here to see the leading scorer for the BC Lions. You might forget about it, but 13 extra points coming into this one adds up pretty quickly for Sean White.
Love me some Sean White.
Four field goals as well.
Territorial pick back in 2007. He's just been exceptional to watch over the years. His way about going and doing it is just different. You might have heard me talk about Sean White. If he's kicking a 30-yarder, he's going to kick it 32. If he's kicking a 40-yarder, he's going to kick it like 42. You know, he's just going to chip it. You know, he's got a bunch of different chippers, wedges in his bag, and he just pulls out one and doesn't overpower it. Super steady.
As Lorenzo Maldon, the second injured Red Black.
I don't think he knew where he was. He's trying to get back in the huddle.
Alongside Frank Griffin, heads to the sideline. Yeah. Hot and humid night here in the nation's capital. Rick Campbell staring down his field goal unit.
32-yarder, 87% on his career. I'd be really surprised if he doesn't make this.
Off. The punter is the holder. Smooth as can be. Sean White, been doing it for a long time, continues to have success. Lions extend their lead.
Across the country, businesses have had to adjust how they operate and make difficult decisions to protect their employees, customers, and communities. While we don't yet evolving how they watch, read, and connect, we're here to help you navigate this together. Cox Media. Better together.
A new Chevy is the smart way to hit the open road this summer. The smart way to road trip and seek new adventures. Go a little farther this summer in a new Chevy. Find new get up and go, find new roads. Enjoy the open road and make no monthly payments for the rest of summer on all 2022 Silverado 1500 pickups. Plus, get 2.49% financing when you finance with GM Financial. Find new roads at your local Chevy dealer.
He sits sixth all-time in the CFL when it comes to sacks, but you can call him Coach Matthew Schinetti on the newest addition to the Lions coaching staff.
134 sacks for John Bowman over his long CFL career, and coming into this week, the Lions defensive line had seven of the team's eight sacks. So I asked him, do sacks mean anything? And John Bowman looked at me and said, no, they mean absolutely nothing. That's what I told my team at the start of training camp. I said, what matters is looking at your keys. Look at Matthew Betts in the first half, active hands, moving around. John Bowman said, I want my guys looking at the little holes, being intellectual. That's what matters, Marshall.
Interesting understudy as Jeremiah Masoli goes down. A little bit of Lions defensive line action right away off of the tenure of John Bowman, and Jeremiah Masoli, a little slow onto his feet, will climb up. And Tim Bonner in the backfield once again.
Yeah, and it looks like he went low, and Masoli just kind of knifed down, and he's coming right inside here. And outside move set him up, split the gap, and just grabs an ankle and hangs on. That's exactly what Matthew's talking about. John Bowman, those little things, doing it right.
Sacks don't mean everything, but man, does he ever like them.
Yeah.
He's a fan.
Pretty good at that, too.
Here second and 16, pressure on, ball tipped at the line of scrimmage.
There you go.
Two and out.
In a row, Shetty. That's awesome.
Active hands. John Bowman's a happy man.
Yeah, here they come. Get your hands up. Free safety coming out of the middle late. Get your hands up. Off the edge. That's all you got to do. That's huge stop right there. Get the ball back so it takes more time off the clock for the BC Lions.
8-2 and outs tonight for the Ottawa Red Blacks. Cashed in on those short fields, but a lot of quick possessions as the coverage team downfield. Justin Howell adds to his special teams tackle tally for the season.
Yeah, pretty impressive. This school right here, Carleton. Just kind of coming into his own at that free safety position on special teams as well.
Couldn't believe he's already in his fourth year in the league. I remember scouting him at Carleton for the CFL draft, and he's worked his way through the depth chart, elevated, wanted an opportunity to play more than just special teams, wanted to be out there as a free safety, and earned it.
Yeah.
Took a couple of years, but earned it, found a way onto the field, was frustrated by the hamstring injury he had that held him out, but back in the lineup and staring down Nathan Rourke, Canadian on Canadian here in the fourth quarter in Ottawa.
Hand counter.
James Butler, nowhere to go.
He was so slow developing. And you see the big boys pulling on this play. And it's pretty simple to watch. You're going to watch the big boys just kind of come over here on a counter, and he's going to finally get the ball over here. But watch the defenders. They're just kind of scraping over the top.
Look at Adam O'Clair at a Laval. Another Dan Bassambombo, one of the Laval linebackers, but Frankie Griffin out.
A big stop there.
And in comes O'Clair.
Got to get a two and out here.
This time Rourke has to throw it. Goes after O'Clair through the air to the sideline. Had to get to the 39. They'll call it a catch. Hatcher has it, and it's a first down for the Lions.
That was the best throw of the evening. That was the best throw of the evening because it was a comeback. And again, it's his favorite target, Keon Hatcher. And he brings him back here and spots it. Oh, my goodness.
You know what that screams to me, Matty, is you watch that and he identified. You were talking in the open of this game about slides, pictures, blinking, seeing things.
Yep.
He identified, to my eye, that's Adam O'Clair. That's a weak side linebacker against one of my best receivers. He waited it out. He worked through his progressions. He knew he was going there.
Right, but the timing and the velocity and the location, you add that to the mental aspect of it, and now you got something. And that's pretty special right there. That's what you want to do, decipher the matchup you want to, pre-snap, and then look the defense off and throw with rhythm and timing. He was able to do that on that play, and that was, I think, his best throw of the night.
I agree. Kenny Onyeka heads slowly to the sidelines as another Red Blacks defensive lineman gets dinged up. Keep our eyes on the pressure here as we go late into the fourth quarter, whether or not the legs are there for that group up front for Mike Benavides to get after Rourke and cause some pressure. They gotta force something here as the Lions lead by eight. We head towards the 3-minute warning.
I think he was just at 300 yards before that throw and put him at, I don't know,
311 now.
311,
yeah.
Against this defense, pretty salty. Plus he's got how many on the ground, Johnny P?
87 yards
on the ground.
Don Perlberg, stats ace in the booth, racking up the yardage for Nathan Rourke throughout the ball game as Butler gets the carry inside, and it'll cause another second down. In the first half, Matty, second down conversions, the Lions were just 2 of 10. In the second half, 7 of 10.
Yeah. You know, I know there's 12 players out there on the offensive side of the football, but you ask anybody, they say if Rourke makes a mistake in practice or in the game, he won't make it again. And that's a stretch, right? Because we've seen him throw two picks here tonight.
Different types of picks, though, right?
Right, but he's learning.
Yep.
He learns quick.
21 touches for Butler. Rourke this time looks to the wide side, fading it down for Rhymes. Flag comes out, caught it regardless. Tejada up against Rhymes as he makes his return to Ottawa. Last year got injured on this field in a Lions close victory when Michael Riley was the leading man in the huddle. Now it's all Rourke all the time.
Dominic Rhymes showing out for his fiance, family.
Waving to the crowd.
Defensive pass interference, Ottawa number 16. That penalty will be declined. First down, BC. This is the 3-minute warning.
Watch this. This is a nothing throw for Nathan Rourke. He just spots it beautifully. Deep throws a timing ball. He throws it out. There's the PI. Still makes a tough catch. Falls right on the money. Huge play.
Rourke loves it. 3-minute warning. Lions lead.
Across the country, businesses have had to adjust how they operate and make difficult decisions to protect their employees, customers, and communities. While we don't yet fully know where this road will lead, we do know you don't have to walk it alone. When you're ready, Cox Media's team of experts will be here to offer thoughtful perspective on messaging and media planning as your customers are evolving how they watch, read, and connect. We're here to help you navigate this together. Cox Media. Better together.
A new Chevy is the smart way to hit the open road this summer. The smart way to road trip and seek new adventures. Go a little farther this summer in a new Chevy. Find new get up and go, find new roads. Enjoy the open road and make no monthly payments for the rest of summer on all 2022 Silverado 1500 pickups. Plus, get 2.49% financing when you finance with GM Financial. Find new roads at your local Chevy dealer.
Yeah, there's your man right there. Dominic Rhymes. on Anthony Tejada, and he starts grabbing on about the 10-yard mark right there because he knows the big body's going by him. And look, he's dropped a lot of weight over the offseason so he can be at a vertical stretch, and he is now waving and looking to his family who's in the stands. And more importantly, his fiance, McKenzie, who's going to get married to after the season. So he's figuring a lot of stuff out, but one thing he's got figured out for sure, and that's getting vertical for this BC Lions offense.
Lions fans love it here as the inside handoff to Butler gets stacked up once again. Controlling the time of possession. Back onto his feet goes Butler, 22nd touch of the ball game. They've really run everything through him and then relied on Rourke on second down as we get the timeout coming from the Ottawa sideline.
Trying to manage the clock right now, knowing that field goal is going to be a two-score game. Got to make something quick when every second counts. So that's what you're seeing from the Red Blacks right now. Trying to give themselves an opportunity. Somehow, some way, maybe forcing another turnover here. Maybe lost yardage. Try to make a field goal attempt even that much more difficult. Definitely didn't want to give up a big play. We saw in last second and medium to long, Nathan Rourke over the top to Dominic Rhymes, and here we go.
Rourke in the gun. Quick drop, looks to his left. Stands in, rips it out to the sideline. It's caught by Lucky Whitehead. On second down, they're going to give him the spot. Lucky will crawl his way forward and sell it. Move the sticks. First down, Lions.
Yeah, he's one receiver right here. And Lucky's going to run a delayed route here because Rourke's got all day to throw. Steps in the pocket, pumps, waits, and then he throws a strike out there in front of Baltimore. And Lucky gets a pretty decent spot there. Like a half a yard better than what he actually gained.
Rourke's up to 359. Passing yards, including 208 yards since his last interception. Inside handoff, Butler jukes one man in the hole, pick up a 5.
You could have put it William Powell in that backfield. Looked like the same type of running style right there. Patience, explosive, pick up 5.
Controlling the tempo of the game are the Lions here as they wander back to the huddle.
Yeah, and then Nathan's got to stay in the huddle here, at least take this down at 1-2 seconds every time. Little things here that I'm sure he's very aware of.
Time, score, situation. Key here with the Lions as they'll hand off again. Butler gets wrapped up in the backfield. And the Red Blacks defense will get a stop. Sean White forced to come off the sideline, but this is going to make it a two-score ball game with 1:28 remaining in the fourth.
60-degree wedge here for Sean White. Yeah, Rourke took the clock down to 2 seconds there. Nice job milking as much as possible. Only thing you can hope for here if you're the Red Blacks is block or mishandled snap. Take control, score, and a two-point convert ties it.
Ottawa defense did their job, but is it too late? Didn't leave much for Jeremiah Masoli on the other side as he sits at just 129 yards passing. No touchdowns on the evening. As they'll take it right down. And call the time.
Well, the second down long throw to Dominic Rhymes was impressive.
No doubt.
The throw to Keon Hatcher, second down right on the sidelines, was even more impressive in my opinion. But that was a heck of a drive to put themselves in this situation.
Sean White will line it up. Just 14 yards away, gets enough under it.
Spotted.
Lions in control of this one. Who will get their first win of the season tomorrow night? The CFL and TSN keeps on rolling with Friday night football action returning to the Hammer. Don't miss the Elks and the Tiger Cats showdown at 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific, and exclusive TSN coverage all weekend long as the panel on site tomorrow.
Yeah, on site tomorrow. And then on Monday, we'll be in Toronto at BMO. And it's an exciting weekend for everybody, every Canadian. Happy Canada Day.
Get out and enjoy some CFL action.
Yeah.
Get to the stadium.
We're
have
grilling
some fun.
Tomorrow.
Grilling.
We're grilling tomorrow. Yes, we are.
Matty D grilling.
That's him.
CFL football. Yeah, what else could you want?
Some cool ones.
As we thank you for spending the Thursday evening of your long weekend with us here on the CFL on TSN. A nice return this time. Terry Williams all the way across to the 49 of the BC Lions.
He's been impressive all night.
A little bit of life, he is.
He's been impressive. I think they found something. Mr. Williams here.
Missing Devontae Dedmon, but he's slowly making him forget.
Yeah, but he's close to breaking some here. That's big time return there, much needed by the Red Blacks. Good night for Tennessee Martin Plotter.
Net yards in this ball game. BC nearing 500. Ottawa at 205. Offside will be called here against the Red Blacks. Completed underneath to Jalen Acklin. And they'll move this one backwards and replay first.
Offside, Ottawa, number 81. 5-yard penalty, repeat, first down.
A little mental fog maybe after the return that time. Terry Williams just trying to hit the waggle, filling in as the late scratch of Justin Hardy.
A little overzealous.
I mean, when you're that fast.
I don't know. I've never
you get, to, you get to the waggle a little bit quicker than some other guys.
Right.
Get a good shot there of Josh Woods. The Red Blacks take the snap here. Masoli over the middle, and it's caught. One-handed snag, Darvin Adams.
I don't think he knew he had it at first, because it was just feathered in there beautifully. Darvin Adams is going to go right down here and get behind the defense, who's dropping, you know, really deep. You can see him already in the back pedal. He gets in over the top. The ball's dropped right over there. One-hands it. Another deep ball.
And this one knocked away. Hands on the back, it looked like, of Jalen Acklin as he's asking for it in the end zone. Incomplete for now. And everybody wearing plaid in this stadium asking Paul Lapolice to go ahead and drop the challenge flag. I don't believe he can with any timeouts left.
We're going to push it deep again.
Masoli in the gun. Second down and 10. Time loads it up. Back of the end zone. Darvin Adams. Incomplete. Flag down.
Oh, it looked like.
Will that go against Adams? No, it'll go against Purifoy. Wow. Second time tonight that he's been called deep in the end zone.
Defensive pass interference.
Ryan BC Phillips hates that one.
1 yard line. It's like he first was down Ottawa.
In behind him by a yard, but running out of room.
Got hands on, but
yeah, I think he got hands on for sure and impeded him from coming across his face right there.
Yep. Yeah, that angle's a little bit more clear.
Yeah, right there. Yeah, that's definitely PI.
So Caleb Evans in, snap into his feet. And somehow, man, that ain't easy to do. Diving into the end zone. Touchdown Red Blacks to get it back to a one-score game with just 29 seconds remaining.
You never know, right? Convert here. And then you have an onside kick. Need two here. Onside kick to get a field goal. Recover and get a field goal and tie the football game. That's what they need. So they need this two-point combo.
Sneaking into that mess is tough enough, let alone having the snap roll into your ankles. Caleb Evans
somehow
dug
he found
out.
It.
He dug it out. Yeah.
Come on, Ottawa!
So the faithful have stuck around here at TD Place are going to see a nice finish. or an exciting one anyways.
Trying to make this a field goal game, as they'll go for the two-point conversion once again in this ball game. Adventures on the two-point tonight here in Ottawa. Masoli looks to his right, pumps, throws a fade ball, back of the end zone. Darvin Adams caught it. Was he in? He was.
Wow.
Tapped the toes.
How about the throw?
And he lets Gary Peters know about it as a little double move on the outside. They ISO'd up one of the best cover men in the CFL and got it.
Going there the entire time. Jeremiah Masoli throws a dime. Just going to give him here and get all that room back to the very end of the corner there. Jeremiah knows it. Let him work. Get it out there.
Beautiful.
Ooh-wee.
Got the left down.
Guess that's all you need. One in the CFL. Well, these guys got some magic here late. Beauty. We've been talking about all night long. Cover teams. Special teams. Sean White. We saw Ward miss one, which was surprising, but other than that, it's been stellar play by the special teams here tonight. Seeing Bobby Dice can't dial up one right here.
Fitting that it would come down to specials, as we've been talking about that barroom brawl all night long.
Yeah.
And I'll say this as well. I think one of the big reasons why this has been such a physical special teams battle, snap in, snap out. Look at the bodies on these rosters. Javon Katoy, we talked about Kevin Francis.
Yeah.
CC Donyanowski, the special teams coordinator for the Lions. Marco Dubois out there
We're
for the Ottawa Red Blacks.
Some large human beings.
About to get after it here on the onside kick. Three-point game hanging in the air. And Katoy stepped out of bounds when he caught it. So that should be a legal kick out of bounds as the first foot came down.
He jumped, came out of bounds, landed out of bounds. That'd be a legal kick.
Yeah, Lewis Ward.
We have a legal kickoff, kick out of bounds. Ottawa number 10.
A little bit too much leg on that one.
Peek at it. Good shot. He jumps, he's in play, he lands out of play. That carries the ball out of bounds, legal kickoff. Pretty simple call. Take a knee, take it to the house, and Nathan Rourke is going to learn a lot from watching this video.
Lots to learn, another step in his progression. As I'll say this on a night where we, for obvious reasons, Canada Day weekend, a special Canadian quarterback, spent a lot of time talking about a Canadian QB playing here in Ottawa. Unique connection, might be unknown to a lot of passionate CFL fans out there. Russ Jackson told me a great story a couple years ago that the BC Lions were incredibly close to drafting him in 1958.
Yeah.
They had the third pick. Ottawa Rough Riders had the sixth. The BC general manager at the time was Herb Capozzi, who was friends with McMaster Athletic Director, where Russ played, Ivor Wynn. As Russ eloquently says, Herb flipped the coin wrong.
That's so Russ Jackson.
Heads, it was Russ Jackson. Tails, it was Bill Britton. Bill Britton from Western, running back, went there, played 4 years in the CFL, and Russ went on to become the greatest Canadian quarterback ever. A win, moving 3-0 on the season now for Nathan Rourke as he continues to find ways to get victories in this young CFL season. The Red Blacks dropped to 0-3 on the year. And the journey for these two clubs will continue through the long haul that is the CFL season. Adversity, fighting through it. A long run for Rourke, and energy in the building to kick off Canada Day weekend. For our producer, John Hines, Matt Dunnigan, myself, Marshall Ferguson, thanks so much for joining us. Lions win 34-31, your final. Time now for SportsCenter.
It all comes down.